a second ago. Darren Granger coming off a remarkable week last week. Threw for 466 yards and three touchdowns. Georgia State comes in here with a lot of talent themselves.
And he has a lot of weapons to throw to. They're going to spread the field and make you defend all these wideouts. They got Robert Lewis on the outside that leads all of FBS in total offense. They have Granger who can run the ball and beat you with his arm. Going to be really excited.
Well, if you like Harleys and points, you found the right party. Kickoff for Brooks Stadium is coming up next as we take a look inside Nissan's Heisman House.
I used to watch the Heisman House every year on TV. And I'd always wonder, is it real? I can tell you now, it's very real.
Take a little bit more up the top.
Now that I've been here a while.
A little bit more.
It's a lot like campus. We have roommates.
Hey, Caleb. Just try and keep it down. It's nap time.
There's a shared kitchen.
Guess who's making cupcakes?
I just want to make a sandwich.
Of course there's a gym.
10.
All right, people, here we go. Looking good, RG3.
No, you're looking good, RG3.
Yeah, so it's a lot like...
You need a room, rookie?
We're doing a tiki-tok.
That's right.
Okay, I think I got it now.
Bound, bound.
Just like campus.
Wait.
I got it now.
You don't got it.
Ally helps you save for the things you dream about faster. We can automatically scan your spending to find you saving. Whatever you're saving for, we're all better off with an Ally.
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing. Now they are a thing. And eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America. Arby's, we have the meat.
Ah, Reese's. They'll get you. They will get you good.
Not you eating on your daddy's white carpet.
Cut the blue joke and give me one of the wings.
Get eight of KFC's new hot and spicy wings for only $4.99.
Oh, man, the way Bryce is able to cover the whole field is incredible.
Yeah, he's really spreading it around.
You guys could help, you know.
Just doing our jobs, Bryce. Just doing our jobs.
Yeah, we're working too.
Thanks for watching the Nissan pregame drive. Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Coach, your Sun Belt opener tonight, a lot of emotion. What is going to be the keys to success in order to get off to a good start?
Yeah, we just got to play our game, protect the football. We got to tackle well. Game simple, right? Blocking, tackling, and just doing the right things all the time. So we're excited to be here in front of our crowd, and I look for a great game tonight.
A lot of familiarity on both sides. How do you keep your guys in check emotionally?
Yeah, we got to play between the whistles, right? We got to just do our job, do what we got to do, take care of the ball. We'll be all right.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
One.
First-year head coach Tim Beck has them 2-1 to start the season. A whole new season now as Sun Belt Conference play gets underway. Georgia State has won the toss, Coach. They elect to receive Liam Gray, the kickoff. And Robert Lewis, who we'll get into throughout the night, a remarkable game a week ago, deep to receive for Georgia State. Sit back. Relax. If you like the point total and you like offense, Conway's your spot. Lewis waves his men away. They'll get the ball first and 10 at the 25. And coach Darren Granger, the quarterback, 466 yards, three touchdowns, second best game in program history a week ago against Charlotte.
And just put up huge numbers with his arm. Explosive plays. They had touchdown passes of 97, 78, 38 yards in that game. He's put on a bunch of weight this offseason to help him. He is a big, good-looking kid at 6'3", 220 pounds. I can't wait to watch him play. He's going to put on a show for us here tonight.
Again, 3-0 for the first time in program history. We'll get into their schedule throughout the night. The story between these two, that's Marcus Carroll, the lead back, and a gain of one. Carroll, number three in FBS in rushing. And they do a little bit of everything as Coastal, their leader, Shane Bruce, in on the early tackle.
Yeah, good start. I think they're going to try to get into the flow of the game. They talked about it, the coaching staff. They want to really let into a flow early of the game, and you'll see that for Granger to get his comfort going.
Play fake to Carroll. Granger going to take a shot, has to scramble out of the pocket, and he's got this element to his game too. Granger, nice gain. Gain of 8. Tobias Fletcher brings him down. And that's where that extra weight kind of helps him in the running situation.
That's what it does, because you can see his athleticism to make you miss, but the durability on the size that he's going to be comfortable taking these shots.
Jamar just short of the first down, 3rd and 1. Carroll, first down, Georgia State.
Good strong run there. They put, and you see that a lot of teams are going to put this, put the formation, put all the receivers into the boundary to try to create an unbalanced look on your defense.
Granger bobbles the snap, able to fall back on it. That'll be a loss of 4 on the play behind the chains now. You haven't done the look. Just Granger just dropped the ball, coach.
Yeah, some of that motion right there. I mean, you can see his eyes getting on the zone read, moving his eyes too early, getting onto that defensive end. But this is something on film you'd love watching do. They're going to spread the field. They're going to stretch you horizontally across the entire field. Let's see how they're going to defend this.
That's a good example of it. A quick shot to the outside, a big gain. That's Tyleek Williams, and Tyleek Williams. We asked them to describe him in one word. They said speed. That a good example of a gain of 21, first down, Georgia State.
And you see how they disguise people. And Tyleek Williams, they put him into the slot. They're going to have an option to run the quarterback or a quick screen. They got the ball out quick to him in the flat. He does the rest.
And here goes tempo. Granger, quick shot outside, and that's Lewis. He drops it. Robert Lewis, as we take a look at our player to watch, brought to you by David Busters. And why wouldn't you, coach? Last week, 6 catches, 220 yards, and 2 touchdowns. That a single game record, what he did last week.
And he's an explosive player. We're going to see him in the return game. They're going to find every different way to get the ball into his hands tonight.
Carroll caught immediately. Tackled by Emmanuel Johnson after a gain of 2. In this game, we expect to be chippy throughout the night. We have talked about the familiarity between the two programs, some of the coaching staffs that have swapped sidelines, some of the players that have transferred in and out. This really is one of those games, and the Sun Belt's kick it off, coach. We expect it to be very emotional.
Absolutely. These programs, Georgia State's trying to establish themselves and get to where Coastal's been the last couple of years.
So now 3rd and 8. Coastal showing pressure, bringing pressure. Granger plants the back foot. Quick shot to the outside, and that's going to be a first down. Ja'Kaius Cradle.
I think that's when you're talking about Coastal Carolina, one of the things that they wanted to do in this game. They want to get pressure and put on Granger early and force him to win with his, beat them with his arm. And you've seen that a couple of times. They're coming after him. They're coming after that offensive line. But I'm going to tell you what, it's leaving them exposed. They're playing one-on-one on the outside.
The big fella, Ja'Kaius Cradle, just caught that. He is down. Over there on the Georgia State sideline. We're going to step aside while they look on him. Georgia State driving the ball here early first quarter. Conway, South Carolina, and a conference opener for Georgia State and Coastal.
There's food at home, but is there a McDouble with extra pickles, a side of fries, and a high C at home? Don't be ridiculous.
Over the years, I've seen what loyalty can do for business. These people have helped me build this company from the ground up, so I'm doing what I can to help secure their future.
where'd you learn to serve?
Oh, I didn't serve, but if your spouse, parent, or grandparent served in the military, you can join USAA.
Yeah, my grandpa did, so I'm already in, but I was talking about your serve.
Oh.
USAA, for the military community.
That looks really high.
It is high.
Whenever you're ready.
Are there any snakes?
Nope.
You sure?
Here we go.
It's time to push your limits.
You're doing great.
Whoa, is that a buffalo?
Babe, that's a cow.
The all-new Subaru Crosstrek Wilderness. Adventure on the edge.
Thursday night football on Prime. It's on.
Thursday night football returns as the Giants take on the 49ers. Stream Thursday night football only on Prime.
It's the final game, folks. This one wins the series.
Struck out with the cheap seats? Important things aren't worth compromising. At Farmers, we offer both quality insurance and great savings. Here, take mine.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
What did I say about using my Old Spice dry spray?
I need long-lasting freshness.
Baby D, we all family. Your lavender is our lavender.
Remember when we used to steal his Old Spice body lotion?
Used to.
This is a story that takes place every Saturday. There's magic rocks, wild animals, techno, and rivalries that go back decades. This story has everything. Want to hear it?
So Ja'Kai's cradled to the tent after getting the first down. Looked like he tweaked his ankle coming down, Coach. But that's a big loss if he can't come back in. 6'4", 217, a transfer out of UCF.
Yeah, and he's their big wide receiver. He creates those matchups, those one-on-one shots down the field where you can throw the ball up and he's going to go get it.
Georgia State converted on third down, ninth play of the drive. The handoff right up the middle. Slip tackle. And that is Carroll. 15-yard gain.
He's their workhorse in the backfield right there. They want to establish the run with Carroll, and that's what opens this up. When they spread the field right now and try to create matchups and run game for the quarterback.
Granger, the leading rusher on the team a year ago, he puts his hat up in there. Tackled on the play by JT Killen, one of their leaders, along with Juan Powell, in a gain of 4.
This is a really good opening drive for Georgia State right now. You come on the road, you're in an environment, they're coming into the student section right now, a tough place to come and win, and they're putting together a great opening drive. Got to take the crowd out of it and build some confidence.
He had mentioned, Granger, in our meetings, that balance tonight was key. And we've seen it on this first drive. Some runs, some throw, and now some defense out of the shot to clears, led by their captain, a guy their defensive coordinator called War Daddy, Shane Bruce.
Yeah, and he is a big, he's your inside backer that you want to see. I mean, he is a tough guy, big, thick, physical inside backer. He's the alpha dog leader of this defense, and you see why. They needed a play in the red zone. He stepped up and made that tackle.
12th play of the drive. Panthers 2-for-2 on third downs. This possession. You got a bunch formation, top of the screen.
And it's going to be an RPO for the quarterback to read the box or take the throw.
One-on-one shot to Lewis. Lewis comes up with the catch. And, Coach, he went to the backside where Lewis was lined up one-on-one. They get another first down tackled by Keontae Lusk.
And you see there's a lot of different things in college football now. They talk about RPOs and different option type plays. He had a bubble screen to the four receivers to the top, a quarterback run option, or the one-on-one slant.
Blinking, you miss it. Panthers running with tempo. I mean, we expect this to be back and forth. This is like catnip to Mullen up here with all this.
Oh, this is great. And the tempo in the red zone, a lot of things. People have gotten down. Instead of going into jumbo formations, go play fast so the defense can't sub with you and get their big guys on the field. As you see, all the subs. Coastal Carolina just brought in their big defensive front for the Shans on the goal line package.
Carroll motions out. Empty backfield for Granger. Second and goal penalty. Trentis Livingston, our referee tonight, replay official Kevin Holmes.
Single timeout, offense, 95. 5-yard penalty, remain second down.
Chalk one up for the Shant student body right there. They're going right into this student body. They were out here early.
I was gonna say.
And they were partying. I was down with them until they were having some fun. They were getting warmed up. They came out, made their presence known here in the red zone early.
If anyone can speak for the student section, it's Mullen. Hung out with them. Granger keeps it himself. How about Granger? Takes him all the way for a touchdown, and the Conway, South Carolina native puts Georgia State up first. He grew up here in Conway and goes 14 plays, 75 yards, and a key block by Travis Glover.
It really was, but you see the width of the formation, how they have that defense spread out so far. Everyone's covered up. They're running an option play to the right. He sees it. He sees the lane covered up, cuts it all the way back. Great blocking, getting into the end zone.
Liam Rickman tacks on the extra point.
It's a great opening drive. When you go on the road and you can put a big opening drive together like that, that's how you want to set the tempo. And this team is a very veteran team. You look at the Georgia State team with 17 of the starters on offensive defense, fourth-year-plus players. They come into this environment, and they want to come out and establish themselves in the confidence of doing this on the road. You see the speed option, but everyone's covered up. The spread formation leaves nobody on the backside edge. Granger sees that, just puts on the brakes and says, I'm going to take it the other way.
So we talked about the emotion of this game. And a lot of it has to do with familiarity with both programs. And an example of it, Coach, not only have coaches and players, coaches have gone, defensive coordinators, offensive coordinators. These are programs that know each other well. You talk about the defensive coordinator for Georgia State. He had this position, Chad Staggs, 4 years here at Coastal. He's now at Georgia State. The offensive coordinator switched sidelines. The players have switched sidelines. That makes this an emotional matchup between the two.
But, and a lot of friends. And it is when you have that way. You have the emotions because you know the guys on the other side. You have a lot of friends. You have former teammates. You have former players that you've coached. Great relationships on both sides of the ball. And trust me, the competitive juices come in and you want to get a win. So you have a lot of, you have respect for your teammate, but the competitive juices are really going to kick in.
Javen Simpkins is going to get that in his five. Simpkins tried to get through the crease, cut down at the 23-yard line. In fact, one of my favorite things pregame, Chad Staggs, defensive coordinator, Georgia State, went up to his former quarterback. He was the defensive coordinator here at Coastal Carolina. Goes up to Grace McCall, gives him a hug pregame. He's like, you know, now I'm going to have to get after you tonight. It's all love because they weren't part of the same program, but all everything Grace McCall knows that his former defensive coordinator is going to be coming out to get him tonight.
And you're going to look. They're going to try to give him a lot of different looks, create pressure, put pressure on him early to see how he's going to handle it. Remember, this is a new offense for him with Tim Becker, a new coaching staff coming in. It's a new offense this year for him, but it does really fit his skill set.
Travis Trickett, the offensive coordinator, came over from Georgia State, spent a few years there. McCall on first down, trying to get it to their talented receiver, Jared Brown. That was not going to be much. Probably as easy as a call you can get from Jared Brown and pass interference.
Yeah, coming out right away.
Pass interference, defense, number 24, spot foul, and automatic first down.
That on Ronald Cooper getting flagged, an 11-yard penalty, spot foul.
And on the RPO, you see it right away, the one thing everyone talks about, Grayson McCall does such a good job, is decision making. And you see it. He sees the matchup. He's got one-on-one, takes the in-breaking route, draws the pass interference early. They're going to be right back up on the ball. It's going to be, you're going to catch your breath in this one because they're going to be lining up on the ball, playing fast, both teams.
That's a player, Brown, they want to get the ball to early and often. He's their most explosive receiver. So first down for McCall. Steps up in the pocket, dumps it outside, overthrows Braden Bennett. Got a hair.
Yeah, guys, Jakaias Cradle is out of the tent. He's been trying to test out that right ankle. They taped it up there. He's been in a lot of pain and showing a lot of frustration. We'll see if he gets back out there.
We'll keep an eye on that receiver when Georgia State has the ball, but now it's shot to clear. Second and 10. Brown in motion. McCall. Great defense. defensive read. Brown drops it. Ball's on the teal turf. And the Panthers have recovered. An early miscue out of the Chanticleers offense.
And both teams this year have done a great job creating turnovers, but both have also protected the ball really well.
So Brykeese Brown.
I think this one's going to be come back as an incomplete pass.
All right.
The field, the reception by the offense, then fumble, recovered by the defense. 10-10, Georgia State.
So Kevin Holmes, again, the replay official. I would bet. Let's have another look at this.
We're going to have some time here. I think they're going to take a look at this one. First.
There you go.
He's on the further video review.
You're pretty, I can tell. You're confident right out of the gate. So they're going to take a look at the Jared Brown, whether it was a catch or not. Remember, it was ruled pass complete and a fumble on the field. Is there irrefutable evidence to overturn it? Sit tight. We'll step aside. We'll let you know after this.
Some people just know that's not going to fit. Those are the people who know to choose Allstate.
That's not going to fit.
What's that?
You need another 4 inches.
Do you work here?
Nope. I just saw you there and I thought I'd save you the trouble.
Nana.
She's a human measuring tape, and she knows Allstate is the right fit for her.
It's not gonna fit.
That's not gonna fit.
What?
Steven.
Some people just know.
Well played. Well played, my friend.
Those are the people who know you're in good hands with Allstate.
Hey, used to have a silver tooth when I was just a pup. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the pendants, I'm a diamond in the rough. Hey. First order of biz, no snitching. I try to keep it silent, but the kids don't listen.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox. So JJ's for lunch?
The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid. Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both.
Meet my boyfriend, Jake.
What's up, everyone?
What is all over your feet?
Your flowers. I study botany.
Resting dad face back there likes plants, too.
Grab some pruners. Let's prune.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels.
I used to go missing all the time. I let everyone down. I even let Shannon Sharp down.
You let me down.
They've been told how you feel yourself doesn't matter. That electrolytes are all the same.
And just like that, they're gone. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade. Could be the difference between dominating and disappearing.
Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
Every day, businesses everywhere are asking,
is it possible?
With Comcast Business, it is.
Is it possible to help keep our online platform safe from cyber threats?
Absolutely.
Can we provide healthcare virtually anywhere?
We can help with that.
Is it possible to use predictive monitoring to address operations issues?
We can help with that too. With the advanced connectivity and intelligence of global secure networking from Comcast Business, it's not just possible, it's happening.
ESPN Thursday Night College Football is brought to you by Allstate. You're in good hands. And Taco Bell.
Replay made easy. Dan Mullen, you were all over it. It's going to be ruled incomplete and overturned.
Yeah, he never really had control of the ball right there.
Pass. By the quarterback, it'll be 3rd and 10 at the 33-yard line, Coastal Carolina football.
So Coastal dodges an early turnover. Now 3rd and 10. See what they can do with it. Just shy of 420 yards per game on the season, just over 36 points per game. McCall, time, shuffles his feet. That's a good throw on third down. Sam Pinckney, the big receiver, gain of 9, going to be just short. The transfer in from Georgia State.
Great route right here. If you see him get underneath the corner, sits in the zone area, settles down, uses his body to protect the ball back from the corner. Just short.
An early decision out of Tim Beck. He's going to punt it. That's anti-analytics right there based on everything we've seen in college football. That's old school.
Beck's yeah, but they've played pretty good defense
that's
year.
Right.
You're on your side of the field. I think you trust his defense. It came after him.
Watching for the flag on the punter. Good special teams by Colster. Ja'Cari Carter. 37-yard punt, 2-yard gain.
I think Evan Crenshaw should have sold it a little bit more right there. There are some people around his feet.
You got to watch more NBA and flop.
Yeah, we needed a dollar for him after that with a flop on that play.
You can earn a dollar and a flag if you do it right. And when you look, like, how many times can you say this? A program that have just launched football within the last 20 years. Coastal in 2003, Georgia State in 2010. Their first FBS season, 2017 for Coastal, 10 years ago for Georgia State. Coach, it is so rare to have two programs that have only been around for about 20 years.
Yeah, and they've both done a great job of building success within the program. And I tell you what, you give a lot of credit to the schools, the administration, the coaching staff for getting these programs where they are as fast as they've gotten there.
When you have a 3-year starter quarterback like Granger, gain of 14, Killen missed the tackle. Panthers off and running first down. Pressure. Granger. Incomplete. I'll tell you what. Shots and clears are being aggressive defensively, and Granger's doing a nice job recognizing it and taking advantage.
They are, and the ball's coming out of his hands, and they're doing a great job protecting him right now because they've shown a bunch of different looks and pressure looks the Shots have coming in different from different directions. That offensive line for Georgia State, their backs, their tight ends they've kept in, have done a great job picking that pressure up early.
Still Carroll. That's Carroll right up the middle. Tackled on the play by Jaquan Griffin. He was the first one there, gain of 4.
Simple zone read plays, and you see Granger really getting comfortable and in a flow of a game. And that's one thing that you don't want to let happen. When you have a quarterback that's as talented as him, when you let him get into the flow of the game, both running the ball and throwing the ball, and he gets in that comfort zone, he can heat up in a hurry.
Ja'Cari Carter, first appearance for him. Transferred in from Merrimack. Almost broke Cooper Kupp's reception record. Is Granger to the outside. That's a good throw beyond. He drops it. That was Kadarius Thompson.
That's the second drop tonight.
Trevor Timmons down on the teal turf.
But you see you can see Granger, even with pressure in his face right there, doing a great job resetting his feet, handling the pressure, getting through his progression, getting through his read. Good ball. Receiver's got to go help him out on those. He's keeping that ball low and away, getting to it late.
That first down, pylon camera, new technology tonight. He would have been short even with the reception.
Could have had another analytics decision.
No, but hey, look.
Robbed by the drop.
Coach Beck decided punt, play defense. Defense
worked
came through for him. Now Grayson and the Chanticleers get the ball
back. You see, there's something fishy. If you just see. You see that when the punt team does that and all jumps out, they see something that doesn't look right within the formation.
Georgia State, first half of the first half.
Georgia State saw something that didn't look right, too.
All right, so everyone's going to talk it over. So are we. We'll send it to some quick advertisements and come back for the punt when we come back.
On a heartbreaking Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
So this is goodbye?
Tech's moving to a new conference.
So we're not rivals anymore? What about our history?
This realignment's bigger than us both, but here. I got you something to remember me by.
Dr. Pepper Zero Sugar?
Zero. Like the odds of you making the playoff. Gotta go.
Aloe
boys hate you and you're overrated school.
I'll hate yours too.
We're still gonna out-recruit you.
We have higher academic standards.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
For all my life, I'll be devoted to you.
You don't have to be there to be there with AT&T 5G.
New Dove Men Body Wash gives you 24 hours of nourishing micro-moisture. That means your skin still feels healthy and smooth now, now, and now too. Get healthier, smoother feeling skin all day.
When you use reward points to get something for free in the McDonald's app and treat a friend with it, they don't have to know it was free. That can be our secret. Earn free food with the app.
Yo, Saban, this goat done took over our office.
And he's using it to send out medical bills.
Good hands.
Hospital bill for Prime.
Yeah!
Did you just say Gap?
He's talking about expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Good thing Coach Prime knows about, say it one time.
Aflac!
Because Aflac gets you money to help close that gap.
Now, how do we get this goat out of here?
Aflac!
Meet one of my new homies. Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Aflac!
Is an official sponsor of ESPN College Game Day.
Elephant would have been scarier.
Hey, cool costumes!
Thanks. What are you supposed to be?
I'm Tacoma!
He's a truck.
Do you, like, turn into a robot or something?
No, but I can conquer any terrain. Tow, haul.
Cool.
No, it's a character I'm working on.
Toyota Tacoma, our hero. Right now, lease a new 2023 Tacoma for just $349 a month, or a new Highlander for only $439 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
Gladys Murray. All she does is worry. She even worries about...
Why is it impossible to hum while holding your nose shut?
But when her AC is making strange noises, there is no worry because she uses Collins Comfort. She knows they'll get her system back up and humming in no time with their same-day service, 24/7, all year long.
No worry.
Heating and cooling problem? In a hurry? No worry. Call Collins at 480-NO-WORRY. Collins Comfort, home of no worry service and pricing.
Coach, Coastal Carolina realized something was up on this punt.
In the little chess match right here, as you see, the Coastal Carolina, the punt return, punt block team, they're getting all lined up. They see something's not right within the formation. You'll see the coaches going crazy on the sideline to signal it. They're going to check safe punt, safe, 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 safe. They all go out because it's a fake punt they think is about to come their way. So they're ready to defend the safe punt. Georgia State, in turn, takes the timeout because I think they did have the fake punt on.
So Cade Loggins now just going to punt it. It's Jared Brown, and the Georgia State special teams runs into it. It'll be a fair touch for Brown. So that's where Grayson McCall, the shot clears, offense takes off. We have two of the top games to kick off your Saturday on ABC and the ESPN app. Florida State and Clemson. Clemson also here in the great state of South Carolina, upstate of South Carolina. And then Coach Prime and number 19 Colorado take on Bo Nix and the Oregon Ducks. You want quarterbacks and offense? Well, lucky for you, we've got Shedeur Sanders and Bo Nix playing some ball this weekend. Doubt Colorado at your own peril at this point.
Yeah, you would have thought that the Clemson-Florida State would be the top 25 matchup coming into the season, not Colorado-Oregon. I can't wait. It's going to be a great weekend of college football.
At Barry Dan Mullen, Harry Lyles, Matt Austin, our rules analyst with you tonight as we get the weekend started of college football. It's a good, hard run. Braden Bennett, Dontre Hunter on the tackle. I love watching what Coach Prime and the Buffaloes are doing. I would kindly ask they handle their business pre 2:45 a.m. 2:45 a.m.
Let's turn it in regulation.
Let's do this.
Not keep the college football final crew there.
And two-thirds of the college football final crew in the booth. 2:45 a.m. We'll be there for you. McCall out of the gun. Second and 7. Rolls right. Has no one. Decides to just throw that away. Pressured on the play by Javon Dennis. one of those leaders that said in the offseason, this team after a 4-8 season a year ago had to change their mentality. Said the offseason was hell, but he knew they had to do it to get to this point. And here they are 3-0 to start the season.
And a lot of changes, brought a new strength coach in there, you would talk about, and a lot of things they've done. But also you have to understand, Chad Staggs for the last several years in spring ball and in training camp has gone against Grayson McCall. And he's going to know some strengths and weaknesses within his game.
He did tell us, Staggs, he's like, look, I'm not going to get in Grayson's head. He's too mentally tough for that, but we're going to get after him tonight. There's McCall stretching the field deep. Incomplete. Flag on the play. Going for Pinkney. Covered by Bryce Keese Brown. And that'll be pass interference. Down to Harry.
You know, guys, we talk about this team changing. Darren Granger said they're more of a mature group than in past years. They've also changed their mentality. A big part of that has been new strength coach Mike Siriano. They've been running a lot of gassers. They had a conditioning test before camp, running 27 gassers. When they came back from the 4th of July break, they had to run 20. But they also ran Stone Mountain, which is east of Atlanta, as a team this offseason. They've credited their success early this year with that.
Pass interference. Defense. Number the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
I'm going to help my boy Trent or something. Like.
Yeah. But the strength coach, I'll tell you what, within a program, your strength coach is your most, besides head coach, I think the most important guy on staff. Sets the tempo. He spends more time with the team than any other coach on staff. And you can see the team, the confidence they said that the new strength coach brought in has paid a lot of dividends.
So another first down via penalty for the Shots. Two set back. Grayson keeps it. Grayson hit hard. Ball looked like it popped out. But he was able to hold on to it, corral it beyond his body, and a loss of two. And Ronald Cooper, they kept elements of the Jamie Chadwell option in this offense. That was a look at it.
It was, and a lot of times Jim's trying to overload. They're trying to run away from the blitz right there. The blitz coming off the backside edge. But a lot when that happens, you saw the defensive front of Georgia State looping out to the front side. They couldn't seal it off. Nowhere for Grayson McCall to go. Negative yardage play.
This is a defense that leads the Sun Belt in rush defense, 83 yards per game. McCall quickly out of the backfield, trying to make a man miss. And this Panthers defense is all over the shot to clears. That was Brayton Bennett on the reception, Tygie Leach.
Yeah, and Gavin Pringle's the guy that makes this play, the transfer in from Bucknell, the corner. He does a great job. He sets the edge, sees the screen, avoids it, slows the play down, turns it back to the inside, and lets the rest of the defensive pursuit
leads the
come
team
and get the ball.
Two interceptions, as you said, came in from Bucknell. Three-time all-conference selection. And a name that is tailor-made for an NIL deal. Pringle.
Uh-huh.
Bet you can't eat just one. McCall, what a shot over the field. Big gain to Tyson Mobley. And that's what the shot to clears needed, a gain of 34. Mobley brought down by Johnson, now in Georgia State territory.
And Grayson McCall, just such a great job. The confidence, sitting in the pocket, anticipation, delivering the ball on the dig route across the middle. And Mobley does the rest, an explosive play. That's what we've been waiting to see out of this offense tonight.
Coach Beck even told us with McCall, he put on some weight in the offseason, about 20 pounds. Change a couple of things that he does. First and 10. Quick shot outside. That's Brown trying to make a man miss. He does. There goes Jared Brown. I'm telling you what, he is a nightmare to try and tackle.
And that's the type of player you want in the slot. When you see, when you're in this offense that they're running here with Tim Beck and Travis Trickett, they want to get the ball. You need a slot receiver that is a utility guy. You can get him, motion him into the backfield, pitch it to him, throw it on quick screens outside. And that's what Jared Brown gives you. You put the ball in his hand, and he makes guys miss and makes special things happen.
Cooper and Hunter missed the tackle, second and two. Trick, Pinkney, ball. Makes a man miss and a first down. Thought there might be some fun inside the red zone from their offensive coordinator, Travis Trickett. They tried to dial up a reverse there, gain of seven. Good for a first down.
And this is the go zone for these type of plays. So if you see right here what they're going to do, they looks like they're going to run the reverse. This is designed to be a quarterback throwback. You see him, McCall, out in the route. Actually defended pretty well by Georgia State right there. And a great decision by Pinkney. Even though the design, I bet all week in practice, they threw it, wasn't there. He tucked it and ran.
So can still get a first down. That's Bennett. And first and 10 and a gain of one. Henry Bryant the third brings him down.
These defenses are getting after each other. I mean, there's pressure. They're loading the box. They're coming after it. And there's we have the opportunity to see some big plays as this game goes on. There's a lot of one-on-one coverage going on the outside.
Brown, Pinckney, Jamison Tucker, Duplessis. We talked about offensive weapons for both teams.
See, Grace McCall, he sees it. He's got man-to-man coverage right here. He's looking at what matchup he wants to take.
Play clock at three. McCall overshoots Brown. Falls incomplete. Cooper on the coverage. Down to Harry. Guys, Marquise Brown looked like he injured that left ankle, but he is back out there now. He's a tough guy. He's one of the leaders on this defense, and it looks like he's going to be back in there to play.
Harry, thank you.
Some miscommunication, confusion there from Brown and McCall. Brown never saw the ball.
Yeah, he had checked. I think you see that. You have that one-on-one. He's trying to get Brown in the corner of the end zone, laid him out to lead him against the pressure. Brown never picked the ball up in the lights.
10th play of the drive. 3rd and 9. McCall takes another shot at Brown. Overthrows him again. Had a decent look. Jeremiah Johnson, a nice job in coverage. It'll be field goal time for Coastal.
And if you don't first, you don't succeed. You try again, and you see it's really the same route. Last time he ran it as a corner route. This time he runs it as an inside fade, getting to the same area is Brown. Again, that Georgia State defense coming after him. He's got one-on-one matchups, but these secondaries are doing a great job in coverage so far tonight.
So Liam Gray on for the 30-yard attempt. Movement. Nope. It's Justin Abraham for Georgia State.
Defense, contact, 5-yard penalty.
A lot of times in these situations, you're going to see it. It's 4th and long.
Yeah.
Trying to get, hey, we have room to give up 5 if you want to try to get a jump. If you have, there's an indicator that we saw. I can't wait to see this. I don't know if you saw it in the Patriots game the other night.
Oh,
that
awkward.
You're going to start seeing stuff like that come out in college football, all over football. I've never seen that. That was an amazing play drawn up by Belichick and his staff.
Decided to incline the penalty. The ball be placed back at the previous spot. Replay 4th down.
Okay, the reason you do that, people are like, why wouldn't you take the 5 yards? It's not going to change your decision to kick the field goal.
Okay.
If you move that up and the ball is on the hash, it's a much different angle for the kicker, and it actually becomes a really hard angle and an awkward look at the goalpost. Kicker's going to be much more comfortable from this yardage being further back when the ball's on the hash.
Okay, so Liam Gray for 30. Liam Gray true. So a good job by Georgia State's defense to hold them to a field goal. Shot to clears on the board, 7-3. And now a quick word from Verbo.
It's your very own safe haven.
Deep behind enemy lines.
Verbo. Football away, baby.
So Sean Elliott, I tell you what, this is a guy who's built this program, very honest with us this week after the 4-8 season, an offensive line coach at heart, an offensive line coach mentality. 7-3 leading Georgia State to their first 3-0 start in program history. And coach, you were talking about moving up the field goal. It's like the difference between a 7 and 8 iron. You might be more comfortable in the 8.
Yeah, it's your yardage right there. Yeah. You don't want to be between clubs right there. Hey, I'd rather be back a little bit than up and in between clubs. And
just a tidy little gap wedge as opposed to a soft pitching wedge. Matty and Mullen.
You don't take your full swing at the club right there.
We know the Ryder Cup.
Especially
next
in the
weekend.
First quarter.
But with all due respect to the Ryder Cup, Matty and Mullen Cup. Coming later. The kick deep. So early on, we've seen what we thought out of Darren Granger, the local kid coming back.
They've been balanced. They've used him as a runner. They've used him as a thrower. I would say right now Georgia State offense very much in sync with what they came here to do.
Absolutely, and they do it by spreading the field. They're going to spread you so horizontally, and talking to the coaching staff over at Coastal Carolina, the one thing they really wanted to do was force the ball sideways, and they haven't done a great job. That ball is getting a little bit too vertical for the Coastal Carolina defense so far tonight.
He said one of his big emphasis, don't force anything. First down, incomplete.
It's kind of the first miscue we've seen really from Granger tonight, the first miss on the throw tonight.
He transferred in from Furman, also a fine college here in the great state of South Carolina, Furman Paladins. A lot of good football out here in the Carolinas. South Carolina's got a number of programs out here. Columbia up the road, Shane Beamer's doing. Wofford Terriers are in town. A nice job there by Coastal's defense, gain of two.
Clemson's been okay for the last couple of years.
Tell you what,
this program here has been one of the top programs in all of college football here at Coastal Carolina. They have fun out here at the beach too.
Oh, the Conway High School football team, they're here watching. I'm telling you, I love this area of the country. Lived in Columbia for a few years. It's good football, good action, and great people. It's Granger now, third down. What a great job by Granger scanning the field. Peter Kikwata brought down by Jenkins. Gain of 21. That was some good quarterback and scanning the reads, finding the guy for a big play.
And it really was. It's a zone blitz right here as you see the pressure come. The backside DN drop, but it's a cover two zone blitz. You don't see that much, but great patience by Granger to see it, read it, set his feet, and make the throw on the backside.
Another good shot from Granger to the sideline. Kikwata, that was a great time for him to make his first reception of the year. That Jakari Carter, forced out by Juan Howell, gain of 16.
Hey, you see, one of the things they're doing is moving the pocket on this play. Coastal's come out with a lot of different blitzes and pressures. Instead of keeping Granger in the pocket, the offense, they move him out of the pocket, make a throw on the run.
From a third and long, DeShonta clears territory. Marcus Carroll right up the gut.
It's a shoestring tackler. He would have extended his lead as the nation's number one touchdown scorer.
Yeah, that's really safe.
There was no one left.
So second and three, final play, first quarter. Granger up top, has Lewis. Flag on the play. And Lewis looked like he had Eubanks beat. Got into him, and it's going to be pass interference.
And he's the explosive player down that sideline. They're not backing down, though. There's a lot of man coverage for these shots down the field. Both teams are blitzing and getting after him.
Deshaun Elliott, they ran out in the field at the end of the first quarter. They are fired up over there on that Georgia State sideline.
Pass interference. Defense, number two, will be 15 yards starting the second quarter. First and 10.
So that's how we end the first quarter. Georgia State spread the ball around. Five receptions to five different receivers. A lot of pace, a lot of speed. And right now, Georgia State on the road has the lead in this Sun Belt opener.
I know why. Jealous of me because the flow nice.
A truck is a tool, but a ram is life. Yeah, it's the wipe the sweat off your brow sort of life. But it's also the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. That looks nice. Innovations, comforts, and powertrains built to power all the lives you live. Ram.
And Doug.
What do we always say, son? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance.
So you only pay for what you need.
That's my boy. And you get out there and you make us proud, huh?
Bye, Uncle Emu.
Stay off the freeways.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
We're the packing and shipping store. The two-sided color printing store. We're everything your small business needs to make it everything it should be. The one-stop, secret weapon to make a lot of noise and be unstoppable store. The UPS store.
My schedule's pretty jam-packed these days. I've got two, we know, three birthday parties on Saturday, and Sunday, that's my me time.
How's that look?
Works for me.
Works for me.
When you need a partner committed to your vision, agents who are realtors are here for it. Here with market expertise that makes a difference. Here for it all, because that's who we are.
There's some things that go better together, like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. With Voya, considering all your financial choices together can help you be better prepared for unexpected events.
Voya, well planned, well invested, well protected.
Where are you going? We have moderate to severe ulcerative colitis. That's the old me, before I started taking Zeposia. Is that just one pill? Once a day. Old me is still catching up with the Zeposia me.
Zeposia can help people with UC achieve and maintain remission, and has been shown to reduce symptoms in as early as 2 weeks.
You're hiking the shorter trail today, right?
Not with Zeposia. Don't take Zeposia if you had a heart attack, chest pain, stroke, or mini stroke, heart failure in the last 6 months, irregular or abnormal heartbeat, if you have untreated sleep apnea, or take MAOIs. Zeposia may cause serious side effects, including infections that can be life-threatening and cause death, slow heart rate, liver or breathing problems, increased blood pressure, macular edema, swelling and narrowing of the brain's blood vessels, and increased risk of PML, a rare brain infection that usually leads to death or severe disability. Tell your doctor if you are pregnant or plan to be.
Looks like Zeposia is really working out. You got that right, old me.
Ask your doctor about once-daily Zeposia.
At the Cracker Barrel, freshly made food at a fair price is just what we do. In fact, we've got over 20 meals under $12. Each served with a helping of care. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
Colorado, Oregon, Saturday on ABC.
Nice morning ride on the Ferris wheel here at Myrtle Beach. Had a cup of coffee, spun around a little bit. Down to Harry.
Coach, one quarter in, what's your evaluation of your team's performance so far?
So far, so good. You know, 7-3 ball game ahead in the first quarter. We got to win the first quarter. Looks like we just did. We got to put this thing in. We got good momentum. We got good energy right here. And these players, they play it hard.
Appreciate it, Coach.
Appreciate it.
They start with the ball. First and 10, ball spotted at the 14-yard line and a gain of one. But they're good in the first quarter.
Yeah, they won the first quarter. They came into the game outscoring people 28-0 in the first quarter, and that's 35-3 on the year. That's a sign. This team wants to come out fast. You know, you see Coach Elliott, he's going to come out fast, and he wants his team to, and they're following the lead of the head coach.
Yeah, he works up a lather. Second and 9, Granger has good protection, and a touchdown, Georgia State. He had one-on-one coverage with Lewis, 13 yards, Panthers strike again. And how about Robert Lewis picking up from where he left off a week ago?
Absolutely. He's an explosive player out there. He's a tough matchup for anybody in the country one-on-one out there. And they're going to take advantage of that matchup. If he's going to keep getting one-on-one coverage, you're going to see them keep feeding him the ball.
I mean, an impressive start to the game for Georgia State. In the second quarter, the drive carried over, 7 plays, 75 yards, and a 14-3 lead for the visiting Panthers.
And if you're Granger right here, you look at everybody in the box, there's no help for him. Everybody inside, the backers are blitzing. It's an RPO. Granger does a great job. They got no help back there in the secondary. It is one-on-one man coverage across the board, and that's a tough matchup. Keontae Jenkins right there, that's a tough matchup for anybody in the country on Robert Lewis. Granger does a great job, sees it, sets his feet patiently, delivers the ball. That's another touchdown. I'll tell you, these teams have been aggressive, and we thought this was going to be a high-scoring game. it could turn into a big shootout if we keep seeing all these pressures and man coverage with all these talented receivers and the quarterbacks that can make the decisions to get them the ball.
Conway's own coming home as a visitor, which, by the way, the home team has never won a game in this series.
Which is unbelievable.
I cannot believe that stat, but it's true. Granger beat Coastal Carolina for the first time in 2021. He is certainly comfortable in this area of the state. That's Javin Simpkins. Past the 15 to the 20. Simpkins to the 25. Flag on the play.
A couple of them down now. Looks like there could have been a couple different ones.
Our official tonight, Trent Livingston. He's been busy early.
Elite McBlock in the back. Return to number 9. Pretty. Be first in Carolina.
So two blocks in the back for Coastal. That's going to pin Grayson and Grayson McCall, and the shot declares deep.
See the first one. You just got to lay off in those situations right now. There's another one coming, two blocks in the back. But all of these penalties so far, though, Matt, have not been as much procedural penalties as they are effort penalties. Pass interferences, you see that, the blocks in the back. They're football plays penalties, which you still don't want to see penalties as a coach, but the mental ones are the ones that drive you out of your mind.
Jensen Hooper Price, the guilty party. Ball now at the Coastal. Pin deep at the 7-8 yard line. Another flag. Pressure comes. McCall able to get out of it. He is brought down. So another penalty flag on the teal turf.
This one might be defensive offsides. I think the nickel
offsides
coming off.
Defense, number 17. 5-yard penalty, remain first down.
Nickel coming off the edge, a little too early right there. Jump starting that blitz.
I'm impressed with your ability to call the play. Call the penalty, rather, but I'd rather not call the penalty. We'll keep an eye on McCall. Came up a little limpy after that hit. C.J. Beasley remains in the backfield. First and 5. Brown in motion. That's where McCall goes. Try to get him in space. 14. Makes a couple players miss. It'll be good enough for a shot's first down.
That's what we've talked about with Jared Brown right there. They want to move him around. You see him starting in the slot one side, motioning over the top, becoming like another back out of the backfield. That's just a quick toss play to him on the outside in the form of a bubble screen.
McCall again to throw. Steps up in the pocket. Goes to the sideline and incomplete. Intended for Pinckney. Missed opportunity there for McCall. The shot's offense. Looks like he had Pinckney behind the defense.
He did, and he's made some really good throws. I think you get a little bit frustrated, the different looks that are coming after him, that they're showing him on the back end. That one, they dropped into coverage. But a guy with his experience, he's not going to be rattled. He's going to be in there. He's going to keep slinging that ball around.
Again, worth pointing out, Chad Staggs, defensive coordinator for Georgia State, spent 4 years at Coastal Carolina. Knows the program well, knows the offense well. And that's going to be a quick shot out of bounds to Kyrie Duplessis. Bringing up third down. How much, though, is that a factor with Staggs, the defensive coordinator? He was here the last 4 years at Coastal, now at Georgia State. He knows Grayson.
He does, but a little different. They're running a different offense this year with the new coaching staff that came in here to Coastal with Tim Beck and his staff. But you still know the traits of a quarterback. And it can get in each other's head. They're going to be playing a little mental game against each other back and forth all night.
So 3rd and 8. It's been all Georgia State to this point. Panthers showing pressure. They bring it. McCall just had to get rid of it. That Georgia State defense has been aggressive, and it's going to be a punt.
They're coming at it from all different angles right now. They're trying to set up the screen right here, but really well read. The guys that getting through. They let the D-line come. You can see guys retracing to the screen up front. Great recognition by the defense to sniff out that screen and force the throwaway by Grayson McCall.
Javon Dennis leading the way, so another punt and a fair catch at the 42-yard line. We had mentioned Florida State Clemson in a big game this weekend. One of the greatest players ever joins us after this.
Whee! Where'd Arby's Buffalo Boneless Wings go?
Whee!
Hot Honey Barbecue, too.
Whee!
Oh, there they are, with fries for $5. Arby's, we have the meat.
A place to reunite with your actual family of five and your chosen family of 105,213. Verbo. Football away, baby.
Experience the joy of home sweet hosting with help from Ashley. Pay 0% interest for 5 years on guest-approved essentials starting at just $17 per month. Plus, save on accessories store-wide to finish every look. Shop and save today, only at Ashley.
You have all the ingredients for this in your fridge. But ask yourself this. Of all the times you've made it at home, has it ever tasted like our McMuffin? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
Hmm.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
So JJ's for lunch?
Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both. The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid.
It's the NFL like you've never seen it before. Falcons and Jaguars will transform into the world of Toy Story in real time. Tune in for Toy Story Fun Day Football, Sunday, October 1st on ESPN+.
Hey, cool costumes.
Thanks. What are you supposed to be?
I'm Tacoma.
He's a truck.
Do you like turn into a robot or something?
No, but I can conquer any terrain. Tow, haul.
Cool.
No, it's a character I'm working on.
Toyota Tacoma, our hero. Right now, lease a new 2023 Tacoma for just $349 a month or a new Highlander for only $439 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
With Chevy Silverado and Silverado HD, you can take on the mountains, or you can move them. With the power of up to 36,000 pounds of max available towing and the confidence of an available 13.4-inch diagonal touchscreen. Whatever your mountain, there's a Silverado for you. Get 0% financing on all 2023 Silverado 1500 pickups plus. Make no monthly payments for 90 days, or get $5,000 total value on this Silverado with a Turbo Max engine. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Thursday night football is about the sport of college football. Tonight we celebrate Charlie Ward. 30 years since Florida State and Ward won the national championship and the Heisman Trophy. And Harry Lyles, you recently caught up with this legend about his impact on the sport and what he's been doing since.
That's right, Matt. I've got a piece coming out tomorrow on ESPN.com on Charlie's 1993 Heisman season. And Charlie, for starters, we've got Florida State taking on Clemson, Death Valley this week. How do you see your Seminoles stacking up against Clemson?
Well, they have a good chance to win, so that's always great when you're on the road. And I'm looking forward to seeing how they bounce back from last week's kind of disappointing win. But they're going on the road. They're playing a very good Clemson team. Looking forward to it.
Without question, and like we said, you're 30 years removed from your Heisman season in 1993, one of the best in college football history. What for you was the most memorable part of that season?
Well, the most memorable part is getting a chance to win the national championship. There are a lot of great moments during the course of that year. Beat Miami on the road, losing in a close game Notre Dame, but being able to win a national championship with my teammates was something that I enjoyed. You know, that was very memorable for me.
It's hard to argue against that. And before I let you go here, I think one of the things people will find interesting about your story is the placement of your Heisman Trophy. Can you explain to our viewers where it's at and why it's there?
Well, It's in the public library in my hometown of Thomasville, Georgia. And we decided to put it because it gives more people an opportunity to stop and see it. You know, I'm proud of where I came from. For it as well, so that they can dream not so much about winning a Heisman, but doing great things.
Without question, Charlie, we appreciate the time. And again, everybody, you can look ESPN.com tomorrow, the 30th anniversary of Charlie Ward's Heisman season. Charlie, thank you so much.
Thanks, Harry, for having me.
Man, what a legend. Charlie Ward. I tell you what.
Remain third down.
Those teams with Florida State that Bobby Bowden was running out there, that guy, he played in the NBA. That dude won a Heisman Trophy and played in the NBA.
Well, I mean, if you remember, people don't remember this. He was one of the guys. Everybody in the shotgun offense now in college football, that's the norm in every level of football. Back in 93, that wasn't the norm. Charlie Ward was the guy. And Bobby Bowden, that offense, sitting back there and in the shotgun running those plays, that was fun to watch.
So third and 11, back to our game.
We're coming after him again.
It does a Warwick Dunn team. What a loaded squad. Granger, pressure, and he's sacked. Brought down by Wyatt Gedeon, and that's going to bring up a fourth down for Georgia State.
Really good job on the blitz disguise right here. They show it's going to be a no deep look. The safety rolls back to the middle of the field. They drop guys out in coverage underneath. Still bring a blitz off the right side, and they're able to get home. Good disguise right there. They've been blitzing, showing some no deep and leaving everybody one-on-one. That time they dropped into coverage with the blitz.
So Cade Loggins to punt. Jared Brown. Let that one bounce into the end zone for a touchback. When we come back, it is the competition sweeping America.
Over the years, I've seen what loyalty can do for business. These people have helped me build this company from the ground up. And I want them to know how much I value their commitment. So, I'm doing what I can to help secure their future. Because true loyalty goes both ways.
That first time you take a step back.
I made that.
With your very own online store.
I sold that.
And you can manage it all in one place.
I built this.
And it was easy, with a partner that puts you first. GoDaddy.
Patrick, Jake from State Farm, explain this bundling thing again.
All right, Coach Reed, let's say these fries are your car, right? And
And this burger is your home.
Okay.
It can be more affordable if you bundle them together.
Kind of like a combo meal.
I'm like a combo meal.
Explain it again with those nuggies.
Bundling, just another way to save with the personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, I'm Elizabeth, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Honey Pepper Pimento Chicken Sandwich is the collab of flavors. The sweet honey, the pickled jalapeno peppers, and the creamy pimento cheese. It is a perfect bite.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Honey Pepper Pimento Chicken Sandwich is the richness of the pimento cheese. When I took a first bite, I was like, go, go, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go chicken, go, go, go get it.
If we want a more viable future for our kids, we need to find more sustainable ways of doing things. America's plastic makers are investing billions of dollars in new technologies and creating plastic products that are more recyclable, durable, and dependable. Our goal is a cleaner, healthier planet for generations to come. For a better tomorrow, we're focused on making plastics better today.
Isn't it absolutely bonkers that you can walk into a store, hand someone a piece of plastic, and they will willingly hand over Reese's Cups? Forget flying cars. This is it. We're at the pinnacle. Try big cups. They're stuffed with more stuff.
Hey, Matty and Mullen, Dustin Johnson here. Welcome to TPC Myrtle Beach, home of the Dustin Johnson Golf School. Good luck this week attempting to play number 17. I wish I would be there, but I'm playing in Chicago. Hopefully you guys can do a little bit better than you did last week.
DJ, thank you. We will be better this week because you're with your college coach, Alan Terrell, also the director of instruction here at TPC Myrtle Beach. 17th par 3, what are we dealing with this week?
Allen Green, probably more like a peninsula green. Flag is back right, 7 off the right. So it's going to be a good challenge, but they knew you guys were coming and they wanted to spice it up for you.
That's good.
No, thanks for having us.
Awesome.
Thank you. Great
All
course.
Right,
great
fun.
Short
Thank
game.
You.
All right. We'll take the tie. Moving on to next week.
So lucky.
So after 2 weeks, the Matty and Mullen come.
It's still 1-0.
I still lead 101.
Matt Berry. I thought I had that Sandy save on you, though.
You did. Second and 11, loss of 1. We'll explain more about the Matty and Mullen Cup in a moment. McCall, pressured, steps out of the pocket, does good job scanning the field, finds Pinckney over the middle, tackled by Leach, and a gain of 8. So what we are doing each and every week on Thursday night college football is you take a look at the Matty and Mullen Cup leaderboard. Matty won. We got lucky. I missed the putt. We're even.
I thought I had that putt, though.
Some of the great parts of these towns or some of the golf courses, some of these areas that people love. Myrtle Beach, one of them. TPC, we were at TPC Southwind the week before.
Yeah, this is a golf part of America here with mini golf, the mini golf capital of the world. All the golf courses here, such a great place. A lot of fun out there. Good luck to Dustin this week playing up in Chicago. We're getting ready for one of the most exciting golf events with the Ryder Cup coming up soon.
So good. 3rd and 2, first down shots. And even Matty and Mullen Cup so big, even Grayson McCall weighed in. Harry?
I was talking to Grayson McCall this week. I told him, hey, you got to pick for the Matty and Mullen Cup. He was like, of course I do. After looking at the analytics, I think Matt's going to take this one this week because Dan's been in the game for so long. He's still thinking about football, so he took Matt. So not quite there, but it's gaining steam, guys.
Trent McKnight, OC for Georgia State, sat down at our coaches' meetings like, hey, I saw you got Mullen last week.
Yeah, don't count me out, though.
Damn right I did. 1st and 10. Motion back into the backfield. That's a good look off of Carroll off the right side. Or Bennett. Check that Bennett. And tackled by Abraham and a gain of 5. So what does Coastal need to do now to get back into this? Down 14-3. They've only had a couple of big plays. The Georgia State defense has done a good job defending.
Yeah, and they haven't really gotten into rhythm, if you've seen that. Grace McCall's had to really kind of force the ball to get some first downs down the field. They're mixing up coverage looks. You'd really like to see them establish the run, but this Georgia State run defense has had a lot of answers. They've shown different looks, tried option, tried zone reads, but that Georgia State defense had the answer every single time.
Looks like a little miss just starting to cut down on the field. McCall to Pinckney. Pinckney makes a man miss, and there's a big gain for Coastal on 3rd down against his former team. Abraham knocks him out at a gain of 20.
And Pinckney's his go-to guy. He has the size. He has great speed. He's able to drive the DB off. Great top end at the top of the round. Good timing. You have Grayson McCall coming. You know that you're going to have the time to make that throw. Makes the catch, turns, gets upfield, breaks the tackle on Pringle, and turns a short gain into a big game.
So Georgia State calls a timeout. Little bit of momentum out of Coastal. Right now, halfway through the second quarter. 14-3, Georgia State.
People are excited about what AI will do for them. We're excited about what AI will do for business. Introducing Watson X, a platform designed to multiply output by training AI with your data. When you Watson X your business, you can build AI to help coders code faster, customer service respond quicker, and employees handle repetitive tasks in less time. Let's create AI that transforms business with Watson X. IBM, let's create.
Full-time fans, your drive never goes unnoticed, and you deserve a reward. Modelo, the mark of a fighter.
Nissan has a car for everyone.
Every driver who wants more.
More turbo.
More freedom.
More electric.
At Nissan, more is all we do.
Stab a silver tooth and I was just a pup. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the pendants, I'm a diamond in the rough. Ay. First order of biz, no snitch. And I try to keep it silent, but the kids don't listen.
Happy birthday,
got another hit, no flinch. And I tell them, send a watch that I can fit both wrists. And with you stab a silver tooth, but I was just a pup. Wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the pendants, I'm a diamond in the rough. Ay.
Your first home sees a lot of firsts. From first loves to first steps. Sure, it can be a handful at times, keeping you up at night.
Come on now.
But with help from the Home Depot,
I did it. Thank you very much.
You'll find the confidence to create the first place you call your own. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
With college football on ESPN Plus, you get the best teams and the biggest conferences, and so much college football action from across the country. So sign up now at ESPNplus.com.
For the love of football, for the love of La Liga.
All season long, student section across the country competing to be the Taco Bell Lip Boss student section of the year. Download the Taco Bell app to learn more. Rain or shine, Teal Nation. Tonight wearing white. Kids, be careful. It's a whiteout and it's rainy outside.
As they say here, it's not just college, it's coastal.
That's right. They embrace it. First and 10. A call to give to Brown out of the backfield. They'll use him in that position. Georgia State's defense up to it. Ronald Cooper there. No gain.
Yeah, and that's the thing you see with Jared Brown. All the different ways is the coaching staff, they want to get him the ball. And you see him, they throw him to him on bubble screens, trying to get it to him down the field. They put him in the backfield to run the option, and they put him in the backfield right here, turn and hand it to him. He's a playmaker they want to get the ball to, but this Georgia State defense kept him bottled up a lot so far tonight.
So second and 10.
You see Brown, they're paying attention to where he is. He's all the way to the outside right now. They're trying to find ways to create different matchups for him.
Looks like Ronald Cooper gets the assignment of shadowing him. McCall keeps it. Georgia State's defense knew it. That is Justin Abram. We've called his name a couple of times, and a loss of five.
And that's huge for all. It's a simple zone replay. And you just see great job by the defensive end. Almost that kind of false read. He runs like he's going to the back to fake the quarterback. Pops up onto the and then on the quarterback. Call that a rise call. So what it is if you're the defensive end, you look like you're going to chase the back and then rise up the field to go tackle the quarterback, see if you can fake him out. And you don't always fake out Grayson McCall, but they did right there.
Loss of six, third and 16. McCall has to check it down to the outside. Bennett, upended. Get seven out of that. John Trey Hunter there. And now a decision for Beck.
This defense is flying around. They got guys running the football everywhere. And that's what Sean Elliott, you see him get fired up before the game. He's running around. He's juiced up as a line guy. Offensive line guys, he wants to see physical play at the line of scrimmage, but he loves to see his defense fly around and make those plays.
So it looks like Beck will play field position again. He's going to send out the punter. Look, and this puts pressure on.
They might have to take a timeout here.
And play clock down to two. And they do.
Either that, you know, this is not a bad situation. You could let it run out and take the penalty.
Georgia State, this is their third.
Or Georgia State took the timeout.
30 seconds.
Always dangerous, I think, in these situations. Georgia State with getting guys off the field. Don't want to give up the yards. This might give Tim Beck a chance to rethink this and maybe go for it right now.
Fourth and nine, sent out the punter. We'll see what decision they make on the other side of this timeout. Down to Harry.
Guys, definitely some frustration setting in here on the Coastal Carolina sideline. Some slammed helmets by the offensive linemen. They've been mostly calm so far, but this is the first time we've started to see them get a little antsy over here.
Yeah, Coach, they have been able to do anything. Just 104 total yards. Grayson hasn't really gotten going. 10 of 17 for 98. They haven't really been able to spring a big play. They've only got 6 rushing yards here with 5:12 left in the half.
That's kind of been a little bit of an issue for them throughout this season. We thought they broke out of it last week, but they played Duquesne here last week. But they have not really established the running game yet this year.
So Crenshaw to punt. That's Carter situated inside his 10, and that's good special teams to pin him inside the 10-yard line. See if the defense can hold up after a punt of 34. With Granger and this Georgia State offense having a really nice first half.
They have, and they're excited. This is a situation now, though. If the defense of Coastal Carolina wants to make a play, they have them backed up against the student section, back to the wall. Big series for them to try to create. They've done a great job creating turnovers throughout the year. Been a big play defense. This is a great opportunity to do it right here.
6 interceptions on the year. That's first in the Sun Belt. Would be an opportune time for them to pick one here, but Granger, the hometown kid on the road with Georgia State, has other ideas. First and 10. Hand off up the middle. And that's Carroll for a gain of 4. 5 minutes left. No timeouts for Georgia State. Does that really change anything on the approach?
No, this part right here, they're running their offense. They're going to put the drive together. If they keep getting down the field, we'll see what it'll change. You'll have to pick up the pace once you cross midfield.
Juan Powell brings down Carroll, gain a 1, and that brings up a quick third down.
That's where they want this. This is where you want to be if you're on defense. You're in front of that student section on their feet, making noise. And they've been coming after Georgia State all night. Let's see if they continue to come after them with the pressure.
This is a big 3rd and 4 for the home team. Granger rolls right, scanned back left, forced out of the pocket. It is broken up incomplete. Michael Mason brought the pressure. And again, Coach Beck elected the punt, put it on his defense, and again, they did their job.
They did right here, but they dropped into coverage that time, and that's what's fantastic. They've been mixing up the looks. We said they've been pressuring them all night. They came. You saw that. Georgia State moved the pocket, expecting pressure. They drop 8. Coastal comes out, drops 8, almost creates the turnover with everybody in coverage. Great, quick 3 and out by the defense, and hopefully the opportunity to put Grace McCall in a good position with the good field position.
Intended for Talik Williams, couldn't come up with it. Brown deep to receive the punt. And that's going to situate itself right at the 50-yard line, perhaps the 49. And so with 4 minutes left and 3 timeouts, Coastal Carolina trying to get something on the board before the half.
Your favorite thing delivered right to your door means that you never have to stop doing your other favorite thing. Nailed it. Order McDelivery in the app.
It's the final game, folks. This one wins the series.
Struck out with the cheap seats? Important things aren't worth compromising. At Farmers, we offer both quality insurance and great savings. Here, take mine.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Allspice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
Hmm.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
So JJ's for lunch?
The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid. Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both.
The new iPhone 15 Pro is here. Built with titanium, and featuring the most powerful iPhone camera yet. Get it with Boost Infinite and transcend to a wireless utopia. The new titanium iPhone 15 Pro on us, no trade-in needed. Enjoy unlimited wireless and the latest iPhone every year for $60 a month.
Chocolate and caramel. And a crunchy cookie. Oh, it's more than more. It's more... Yes, it's more
There's more to a Twix.
Teeth sensitivity is so common. It immediately feels like somebody's poking directly on the nerve. I recommend Sensodyne. Sensodyne toothpaste goes inside the tooth and calms the nerve down. And my patients say, you know, doc, it really works.
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing. Now they are a thing. And eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America. Arby's, we have the meat.
On season 6 of Fansville by Dr. Pepper, things are heating up.
Mom, Dad, I have a girlfriend, and she likes college football.
The stars have arrived.
I made my choice. This season, I will be drinking
Dr. Pepper, strawberries, and cream.
And everyone wants a taste of fame.
Welcome back to Chuck's Take, because every fan needs a podcast.
To get a thick color, I use 2 coats of maroon. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
I love your nails.
Thank you.
Kevin Connors in studio coming up on the Twisted Tea Halftime Report. Sam Acho and Trevor Maddich will join me. We'll get the guys' thoughts on our first half. Plus, we'll look ahead to that colossal showdown Saturday in Eugene, Colorado, coming to town. And we'll chat with Washington quarterback Michael Penix Jr. Coming up when you join us at the half, Matt, huge thanks to Dan Mullen for getting me in the Delta Lounge this week.
Oh, yeah, Dan. Hey, KC. Mullen loves flexing his Delta power. Yeah. Loves it. First and 10. McCall cannot escape the Georgia State defense. They have been all over him tonight. And that's a loss of 7, bringing the shot to clear his rush yards in the first half to minus 1.
It is, and it's crazy. We're used to seeing Grace McCall put up rushing yards. He has over 1,000 yards on his career. And so far, through 4 games, he has negative yards on the season. You see this, with the exception of the one great drive, they've really not been in rhythm offensively all night tonight.
Swint and Pringle there for the sack. 2nd and 17. Keep it on the ground, right up the middle. Space for Bennett. Bennett gets it all back, and a first down for Coastal. Gain of 19. Tripped up by Jeremiah Johnson. That's exactly what the shot to clear is ordered.
And they're going to try to hustle up on the ball. But you can see right here, misfit on the defense. 2 players off the blitz ran up the field to Grayson McCall. No one had the back on the read option. Big run.
Good call there by Trickett. Trying to make the play now. McCall keeps his eyes downfield. Couldn't find anyone. Flag on the play. McCall slides. Likely going to be a hold coming back.
Right in that holding area.
Holding offense, number 58. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, 2nd down.
Thomas Johnson, the young O-line. And Coach Beck told us it's a mix of young offensive linemen.
Yeah.
This is one of those penalties this time and a half, this time of the game.
These can be drive killers for you. You just have your first big explosive run. And it's tough right there. Your quarterback's scrambling around. You're trying to block and protect for him in the pocket. He gets out of the pocket. Little grab. I didn't see a whole lot there.
Javon Dennis was the player held. He's been a little bit of a game record tonight. So now 1st and 20, ball on the 49. Pressure again. Quick shot. Incomplete.
Dude, the coverage has been fantastic tonight. There's a lot of man coverages being played. A lot of blitzes and the defense, both sides of the ball, getting after it right now.
Bryce Brown on the coverage.
And I know he got banged up earlier, but look at him. I mean, he's drawn the tough assignment of Sam Pinckney with his size and his speed, and he's got him locked down. He's all over him right there.
So now 2nd and 20. All 3 timeouts left for Coastal.
Just want to try to get part of it back right here. Get yourself, you potentially have 3 more downs in this situation.
And at this point, field goal makes it a 1-score game going into the half without having your best offense. That's a run with Bennett. wiggles his way through. They're brought down by Hunter. So now third down after a gain of five, going to be third and long, third and 15.
And you say, why do you do that in those situations? Well, like we said, again, this is now you want to get into third and long. Don't be shocked if they even just try to get part of it back right here to put themselves in position.
So Georgia State substituting in three fresh bodies for this third and 15. They rush three, the swing out of the backfield to Bennett, see if he can get on his own. And Bennett, that was a good job of yards after the catch. Missed the tackle, slipped by Cooper, gain of 10, and again, decision time for Jim Beck.
And I think he made that decision on third down. You don't call this play. Great effort right here by Bennett, breaking the tackle, going, splitting the two defenders, getting up the field. But that play call was called when you're saying, we're going to take a quick check down throw. We're anticipating going for it on fourth down.
Because this makes it a 51-yard field goal.
A little bit, I think, too long right now for Coastal. They're going to let the clock run down, probably take a timeout, talk about it, get the right play call here.
What is the right play call, fourth and six, with what you've seen out of Coastal tonight?
Well, you're going to try to spread the field, and what they're going to do is they're going to try to maybe, you can see Pinkney on the backside one-on-one. If you get man coverage, you're going to try to leave him singled up on the backside. Then you're going to create a zone beater, maybe three receivers to the front side or empty, trying to create a matchup with Jared Brown or some of the other receivers into a zone concept beater on the three receiver side. And let Grayson McCall spread it out, make the decision, deliver the ball. And you're looking for that mid-range throw anywhere from, you know, about an 8-yard call down the field.
ESPN Plus, the home to more than 50 Sun Belt football games this season. Saturday's featured matchup, South Alabama, which, by the way, they went into Stillwater, smacked around Oklahoma State. They've got Central Michigan. 5 Eastern, Nevada travels to Texas State to take on the Bobcats. To sign up, go to ESPNplus.com. So Liam Gray is going to come out for the field goal. Change of heart for Coach Beck in a 51-yard attempt. Coastal starts with the ball, third quarter. Could be big if Gray nails this. Snap clean, kick on the way. Does Gray have the distance? No good. And that was probably 6 inches.
Game of inches right there, but that's one of those, and you take the time out, you're thinking about it, talking to the special teams coach, saying, I think he's got the distance.
I mean, this was so close. Have a look from our end zone cam. Oh. There's Sean Elliott.
He's got a good, and that's not rain coming down right now in that mist. That's pure sweat coming off of him and his excitement and energy on the sidelines right there.
And so now, 57 seconds left. What do you expect out of Granger and Georgia State?
Well, we know they're explosive offense. They're going to try to score right here. They spread the field and see if they can make a play.
No timeouts. Clock stops because we're under two. New rules. Quick shot to Tyleek Williams. A gain of six. Georgia State typically plays with tempo. Nothing new to them.
One of the things that makes them hard to defend and they spread the field this much is Granger's ability to run. So you've got to keep your eyes on him and then defend people. Look, they got a one-on-one matchup up to the wide side of the field.
Second and four. Granger nearly picked off. The captain, Shane Bruce, had the gloves on it. Now third down.
Little flood concept right there, and that's the guy he's reading. You can see him be a little bit careful. They're looking at that flat defender, high-lowing him. Not a great read by Granger. Let's see if they try to get back. They got the one-on-one matchup again up top.
Bruce is going to want that one back. They elect to run it. That's going to be a first down. Georgia State and more. There goes Marcus Carroll, and Carroll has now put Georgia State in a position where they can chuck it to the end zone a couple times. Clock's going to stop. They'll have to come up and clock it after a gain of 30. So there's the clock by Granger. Now they're in a position, ball at the 30-yard line. Granger's got the arm and the weapons, coach. They've got a couple of looks at the end zone.
And this is the situation, you're Granger, that you want to be in. You want to show, hey, I'm the guy in the two-minute drill. It's second down. right now, we're in a situation where the clock's at. It's a first down, out of bounds situation. And that's what you have to think, because if you don't get the ball at a first down or out of bounds, the clock can run out on
you. So we're playing, you're playing for either three quickly or yeah. shot the end.
You're going to try to get the ball down the field, but it's got to get down the field right here. So it's got to be at least a 10-yard gain to stop the clock or get out of bounds.
And there it is. Granger just to the outside quickly. Kadarius Thompson now 16 seconds down to 15 seconds and a third and short.
Well, in a great situation because now you're third and two. Again, it's first down, out of bounds. Clock stops on a first down. So now the whole playbook's open because you only need 2 yards to get that first down to stop the clock potentially on the play. So your whole playbook's open to you right here.
Ball at the 22 would be a 39-yard field goal attempt if it stayed here on an incomplete. No timeouts, have to get out of bounds. Granger quick, right side, executed perfectly. First down, Jakari Carter. And this is a under-minute clinic by Georgia State. Key blitz pickup there after a gain of 6. The running back, Carroll, stopped Bruce on his rush.
And great job by Granger. Relaxed, makes the throw. They're giving him the throw out of bounds. Now what you're going to see in 11 seconds, he's got to have the clock going in his head right now. You're going to say, we're going to go try to take a shot at the end zone. And if we don't get it, make sure we're coming away with 3 points right here.
Cannot take a sack.
Can't take a sack.
Cannot take a sack.
You can't throw the ball in the field of play short of a first down or getting out of bounds.
This is what having a veteran quarterback can do. 3-year starter here at Georgia State. Granger looks, pressure, looks, can't take a sack. Gets it out of bounds. That internal clock was working. Mason brought the pressure. 5 seconds left. Nothing left to see here. Tried out the field goal unit.
Yeah, and that's a situation. They have that play called, they ran a 4-vertical play with motion that they're going to try to throw it in the end zone. Great job by Granger. He didn't like the look. Rolled out of the pocket, so he's not going to take a penalty for intentional ground. He gets outside the pocket, throws it away, sets his team up for the opportunity to get points at the end of the first half.
Liam Rickman, an original walk-on for Georgia State. 33-yard attempts to make it 17-3 at the break. Kick on the way. It is good. And so Georgia State will take a 17-3 lead to the half. Maybe not as many points as we thought. Coastal Carolina, a little bit of a struggle getting the offense going. Remember, the home team has never won in this series. 17-3, Georgia State at the half. Time for the Twisted Tee Halftime Report. Kevin Connors, Sam Botcher, Trevor Maddich. No interview, Riv. You get all of your time.
And that's a win here for us on the Twisted Tee Halftime Report. Matt Barry, thanks so much. I mean, if anyone could use a Twisted Tee, it is Sean Elliott, who has worked up a lather.
A lather? He's sweating buckets right now. He's a longtime offensive line coach. Wouldn't you run through a wall for this guy?
You could feel the passion, the energy. He probably wants to be out there himself, but his players are following his lead.
Look at that look on his face. I'm terrified, and I'm over here.
You're dealing with some serious swamp there in Conway, South Carolina right now. Welcome into the Twisted Tee Halftime Report. Texas Hall of Famer Sam Acho, BYU National Champion Trevor Maddich, Kevin Connors here with you. It's a Georgia State defense that was utterly gashed in the opener against Rhode Island. Trevor, why is tonight a different story?
Well, they're flying around like their head coach is flying around, right? They figured, I think, that because they were getting gashed anyway down the field, they might as well just attack, and they did. And there's a third and eight play in the second quarter that shows exactly how this is working. The Chanticleer offense doesn't have a chance to get things going because they attack. It's an all-out blitz, and I want you to keep an eye on big Javon Dennis. Dennis is going to rush unblocked. That's what you want to watch on that part.
That's what you want to watch. But there's a drill that you do. It's called the redirect drill. Javon Dennis gets upfield. But while you're watching Javon Dennis, I want you to keep your eye on Henry Bryant. He's 6'2", 290, going upfield full speed, immediately redirects. So you see the pressure? Look at that redirect. Let's watch it one more time. Watch what you do. This you practice it every single day. Full speed, all out, go, go, go. Redirect. Those are the drills. Those are the things that you do to stop offenses from making plays.
So they attack the quarterback. And then when they try to run a screen in the face of that blitz, which is what you want, they attack the running back to receive the screen. There's nowhere to go. Yeah.
They have really puzzled Grayson McCall, who obviously has had all that success at Coastal Carolina, and a very different first half than we expected here. Georgia State in control, up by 2 touchdowns. We'll take a timeout here on the Twisted Tea Halftime Report, and when we come back, we'll look ahead to the gigantic Pac-12 showdown in Eugene on Saturday. Coach Prime coming to town to take on the unbeaten Ducks.
This halftime report is presented by the refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Please drink responsibly.
He didn't go to college. I never asked for a raise. He didn't wear fancy shoes. I never took out a mortgage. His friends didn't belong to a country club. His parents didn't have a will. So he worked hard and invested wisely, not in stocks or bonds, but in others.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels.
I used to go missing all the time. I let everyone down. I even let Shannon Sharp down.
You let me down.
They've been told how you feel yourself doesn't matter, that electrolytes are all the same.
And just like that, they're gone.
Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade. Could be the difference between dominating and disappearing. Gatorade, rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
Ladies and gentlemen, the power of a word. The anticipation, the adrenaline, the hair on the back of their necks rising. The crowd, the score rising, greatness rising, the sun rising. Sometimes a word is best left all by itself. The Sun Belt Conference, 14 universities, 10 states rising.
Okay, hon?
Yeah. Oh, what's with the stubble?
I'm not going to shave until we have to fill up the hybrid again.
That's done.
Morning.
Is it?
Now?
How far will you go in a Toyota hybrid? Right now, get 4.99% financing for 48 months on Camry, Corolla, RAV4, and Highlander hybrid models. Toyota, let's go places.
It's time to enjoy the best season of the year. It's time for fall at Las Palomas Beach and Golf Resort. Find deals at LasPalomasResort.net.
Intuitive sit to start in the all-electric ID4. It's the little things. It's a VW. Lease the 2023 all-electric ID4 Pro during Fall Fest for just $319 a month after an EV lease bonus and customer bonus.
All you want is an opportunity to win, to be amongst the elite, to be amongst the best. And darn it, I'm going to give you that. This ain't got nothing to do with the naysayers.
Can he get the players there?
Keep them together?
I don't remember him winning anything.
Colorado stinks.
This is about us. When we started this journey, we told you it was going to be trying. It was going to be tough. But you endured it.
It's prime time for Florida football.
We ain't got next.
Touchdown!
We got now.
Sanders.
We ain't coming no more.
In a crowd, no good. Buffaloes win it.
We're here. Do you believe in that?
Well, he ain't hard to find on Saturday, 3:30 Eastern time on ABC. Coach Prime in Colorado head to Eugene to write the next chapter of what has been a Hollywood story here, although Shedeur Sanders has been pressured a lot this season. Well as he's played, he's pressured more than any other quarterback in all of college football. Trevor, what can Oregon take away from what Colorado State did well last week?
Heat him up. It's been a party for Colorado, right? And Oregon wants to be that parent that comes home early and breaks it all up, makes everybody go home. And from the CSU tape, the Oregon defense will see that while it's hard to stop Shedeur Sanders, you can overwhelm his protection, and that causes a lot of dominoes to fall in a bad way for the Colorado offense. They really struggled, like you said, Kevin, to protect him. So here's one of the dominoes that falls. He can't wait for downfield routes to develop like he wants to. He's pressured, so he throws the ball where the linebacker is, and the linebacker gets a tip. Now, what does he really want to do? He wants an extra beat in the pocket to let his receiver get into the hole between the zones. So it's a clear passing lane. That's one of the dominoes that falls, Sam.
But another domino is play calling. It's first and 10 right now. You have 2x2, receivers wide, 4 down linemen rushing. Then you have 6 defenders all within about 7 yards from the line of scrimmage. Normal play calling, I want to go deep, take a shot. But if you don't trust your offensive line, you change your play call. You call a screen. And what happens when you call a screen? You have 6 defenders playing zone, all eyes on the ball. The screen is done.
But Shedeur Sanders being Shedeur Sanders, he found a way to make magic anyway. Let's go to the 2-point conversion in overtime. 5 guys out in the pattern. Only one will be open. All out blitz. 2 free runners. Can Shedeur find the one open guy and then get the ball to him even though he's being shoved in the chest with the ball still in his hand? Well, yes and yes. But he was at the very limit of his time. And his receiver, Xavier Weaver, says, yeah, that guy's pretty good. But this is what Oregon's defense will see. Heat him up. They think they can do what Colorado State did, only a beat faster. And that would make Oregon's defense a busload full of parents to break up that party.
Well, you know who else might be on that bus? It's not just Oregon's defense, also Oregon's offense. Oregon has a number 2 scoring offense in all of college football, number 5 passing offense. And it's not just what they do in the passing game, it's also in the running game. This Oregon team put up 81 points in week 1. They went backdoor and they beat Texas Tech. And it's guys like Tez Johnson. It's guys like you're seeing on your screen, Troy Franklin, who had 9 touchdowns last year. This team is on the verge of being elite, and they can show it off this weekend. And so, yes, they're going to rely on their defense, but it's that offense and the offensive explosion that's going to give Colorado issues, especially without Travis Hunter.
58 points per game. You said it's second best in all the FBS. They're 3 touchdown favorites over Colorado, although pick against the Buffaloes at your own peril. This one kicks off 3:30 Eastern Saturday on ABC. We come back, speaking of elite and great offenses, we're going to hear from Washington star quarterback Michael Penix Jr. That's next.
We're kicking off game day with a Twisted Tea drop. We're surprising real Twisted Tea fans who love the smooth and refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Real brew tea with 5% alcohol. Keep it twisted.
Whee!
Where'd Arby's Buffalo Boneless Wings go?
Whee!
Hot Honey Barbecue, too.
Whee!
Oh, there they are, with fries for $5. Arby's, we have the meat.
Moderate to severe eczema still disrupts my skin. Despite treatment, it disrupts my skin with itch. It disrupts my skin with rash. But now, I can disrupt eczema with Rinvoq. Rinvoq is not a steroid, topical, or injection. It's one pill once a day. Many taking Rinvoq saw clear or almost clear skin, while some saw up to 100% clear skin. And they felt dramatic and fast itch relief, some as early as 2 days. That's Rinvoq relief.
Rinvoq can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB, serious infections and blood clots, some fatal, cancers, including lymphoma and skin cancer, death, heart attack, stroke, and tears in the stomach or intestines occurred. People 50 and older with at least one heart disease risk factor have higher risks. Don't take if allergic to Rinvoq, as serious reactions can occur. Tell your doctor if you are or may become pregnant.
Disrupt the itch and rash of eczema. Talk to your doctor about Rinvoq.
Learn how AbbVie can help you save.
Ally helps you save for the things you dream about faster. We can automatically scan your spending to find you saving. Whatever you're saving for, we're all better off with an Ally.
Fridays. It's almost like whoever named the best day of the week was trying to tell us to celebrate it with fries. Free Fries Friday at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
You're watching the Twisted Tea Halftime Report.
It's Sam Acho and Trevor Maddich. Kevin Connors here with you. I know it's early, look, week 4, but we're already talking Heisman. Caleb Williams, of course, the reigning and defending Heisman winner, but Michael Penix Jr., the second best odds We had a chance to chat with the Washington star quarterback in our pregame.
What's been the hardest part about your transition to this new offense and bringing guys back? I know you're second year, but what's been the most difficult part in this second year?
I wouldn't say it's been too much things that's difficult, you know, but it's a lot of things that we want to improve on, and that's just our efficiency within our plays, you know, stuff like that. You know, if it has stuff to do with movements and stuff like that, make sure we're moving quick and just giving myself time to be able to see the picture and, you know, just going out there and execute each and every down. You know, I feel like we get times where we know that we should be able to score in the red zone, and this year we had a couple penalties that stopped us from doing that. So we want to just make sure we clean up those small details that could stop us from being great.
Although, if we're being honest, there's not a whole lot of cleaning up to do. Michael Penix Jr. a week ago at Michigan State, 473 yards and 4 touchdowns. He's now the holder of the top 3 passing games in Washington football history. Darren Granger was chucking it all over the yard against Charlotte a week ago. Tonight, he's using his legs to help Georgia State open up a 17-3 halftime lead.
This halftime report is presented by the refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Please drink responsibly.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox. So JJ's for lunch?
Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both. The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid.
Hey, corporate types, will you stop calling each other rock stars?
You're a rock star.
You are a rock star.
Rock stars, please.
You know what it takes to be a rock star?
I've trashed hotel rooms in 43 countries.
I was on the road since I was 16.
I've done my share of bad things. Also, your share of bad things.
We know that using Workday for finance and HR makes you great at your job.
That don't make you a rock star.
Oh, Ted in finance, you're a rock star.
Hey, Liz in HR, can you do this?
Unless you work with an actual rock star.
You are a rock star.
Thank you.
Who's a new guy?
Hi, I'm Oswald.
Hello, Oswald.
Give it up for Pam. Pam, you are a rock star. I wasn't gonna say it.
The place that levels the playing field, where lives change and leaders emerge. In the heart of downtown Atlanta, this is the place that shares sidewalks with Fortune 500s and the state capitol. The place the Washington Post called a hotbed of innovation and the New York Times an engine of social mobility. And Ludacris?
I will continue to make you proud and to be an example of GSU's determination and resilience.
This is the place making a better Atlanta, a better world. This is Georgia State University, the place for all.
6 ranked matchups coming your way Saturday and a veritable smorgasbord on the ESPN family of networks.
Yeah, I'm excited to see that Miami team. Yes, they beat an A&M team that was ranked. Now they have a chance to continue building.
And it's going to be a defensive challenge for Michael Penix Jr., the Washington quarterback. Cal is stout on that side of the ball.
Number 1, Georgia against UAB, 7:30 Eastern, ESPN 2. Big time first half for Robert Lewis. And Georgia State, 2 touchdown lead at the break. Second half from Conway is next.
We're kicking off game day with a Twisted Tea drop. We're surprising real Twisted Tea fans who love the smooth and refreshing taste of Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Real brew tea with 5% alcohol. Keep it twisted.
If your cover is blown, there is no saving you. What's your name? Can you escape before they know what you've done? She's in. Shelves. Shelves smart enough to see. Sense. React. Restock. So Caramel Swirl is always there for the taking.
Okay, let's scamper along. Wow, it's a whole herd. Well, you know what? More time for me to spend in my new Tundra. And a turtle. Guess it's time to catch up on my reading.
Cherish your time in any new Toyota. Get 3.99% financing for 48 months on Camry, Highlander, RAV4, and Tacoma. Toyota, let's go places.
A truck is a tool, but a Ram is life. It's the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 2.9% financing for 72 months, or current FCA owners get $8,980 in total values on the 2023 Ram 1500 Bighorn Crew Cab.
Pandemonium, it's showtime!
The Sun Belt opener for Georgia State and Coastal Carolina. Ball at the beach, Myrtle Beach, and Conway. It's been all visiting Panthers 17-3 to this point. Welcome back into the booth. Dan Mullen, Matt Berry alongside. Coach, what does Coastal Carolina have to do to get back in this game?
Well, they got to establish a run. They get the ball to start the second half right here. Their running game has just been stymied all night long, and it's really hurt the flow of their offense. So if they can establish a line of scrimmage, get some running game going, stay a little more balanced, they'll be better.
Time now to look at our game flow brought to you by Progressive. And early on, Georgia State offensively was very effective.
Yeah, we thought it was going to be a quarterback battle, and it has been in one way. Darren Granger has come out and put on a show, running the ball, throwing the ball, taking advantage of matchups, making great decisions. Now, Grayson McCall has been stymied constantly by this Georgia State defense. I don't want to say he's struggling himself. I think it's great defense by Georgia State in this first half.
So we'll see if Deshaun DeClears can do anything with the first possession of the third quarter. Javon Simpkins on the receptions as we now take a look at the first half stats brought to you by Chewy. And Coach, not pictured here, but total yards for Coastal Carolina, 131. The rushing yards for the Deshaun DeClears just 23.
And they have, and they've kind of come on some different situations. It's been the lack of consistency in the run game that's hurt them, made them one-dimensional and not letting them into the flow of their offense. If you can't run the ball, it's hard to get the tempo going, get up with the ball and quick run that tempo offense. They've really struggled tonight with that.
By the way, shout out to Chewy for the first half stats and the auto shift for O'Shea's food. Amazing. First and 10 now, above 25. The give to Bennett. They are going to try to get that running game going, and much like we saw in the first half, Braden Bennett unable to get the yardage.
And great defense right there by Georgia State. Just nothing special, just everybody in their gaps, filling their gaps, proper support with the safety coming down and the corner squeezing the ball inside, stopping the counterplay. And there's nowhere for there's no holes in this through this defense for them to run the ball.
So second and 9 after the gain of 1. to this point one-dimensional. McCall to throw. Looked outside, decided to keep it. McCall's got that in his game, and a first down Coastal Carolina. Down to Harry.
Guys, I grabbed Tim Beck coming out of the locker room here at the half. I asked him, hey, what do you guys got to do to get back in this game here? He's like, look, we just got to give ourselves a chance. We're only down two touchdowns, but we got to play fundamental football, not shoot ourselves in the foot with penalties, and we'll be okay.
Harry, thank you. And rushing yards by any means necessary. That's a positive rushing play for this offense.
And that's what it was. They looked, they thought maybe he had a different look. They rolled the coverage to a too high look to take the passing game away. Grayson McCall saw that and saw a hole, took off up the middle.
So Beasley and Bennett both in the backfield split off McCall. First and 10. Trying to get anything going. And how about the effort by Beasley? That run was going nowhere. He kept those feet moving. Stutter step to the outside and a gain of 13.
And you already see some of the adjustments they're trying to make. They go to the two-back look. We haven't seen this with the two backs in the backfield, that split-back look right there. Trying some different looks to see where they can find a run advantage against this tough, stout Georgia State defense.
So already 26 yards on this drive, just 23 rushing yards the entire first half. Pressure comes. McCall the handoff. And there we go. Another run for Coastal. Bennett wanted more. Seven will have to do. Leach brings him down.
That's the same play. Just came right back to it again. Even with the safety blitz coming off the edge right there. The safety comes up the field to defend Grayson McCall. That's the threat he brings. You have to defend him in the run game. Creates an extra lane for the back to run the ball.
Now second and three. Bennett motions out. Looked that way for a minute. Good job by McCall coming back to the middle of the field. And that's Beasley out of the two-back set. That's 13. That's a shot's first down.
And this is what people get excited with Grayson McCall at the next level. Look, I don't have it. I'm sliding in the pocket, start to scramble. I know where my check down is. Don't even need to look to find him. I'm able to get the ball in my hands, check it down, move the chains.
And with big Javon Dennis bearing down, able to move away from that pressure, make a positive play. Spotted at the 29-yard line of Georgia State. First possession, third quarter. We've seen this two-back set already. They're going to keep riding that. Two-back up the middle. New back on this one, Max Baltazar, gain of 7. First carry of the night for Baltazar.
Again, it's the same play. They're running a split back inside zone. You see them looking to the sideline, so they're trying to think which way they want to check the play off the rotation of the secondary.
And now early movement from Coastal. And that'll kill you.
But this is what Harry just talked about coming in after halftime.
False start, offense, number 66. 10-yard penalty, 5-yard penalty, replay, first down.
Some featured football games, ESPN Plus this Saturday. West Virginia hosts Texas Tech. Ooh, that's a good one. West Virginia coming off the backyard brawl.
It was a big win for them.
How about Florida ranked after the win against Tennessee? They've got Charlotte at the Swamp. 7 Eastern, ESPN, ESPN Plus, ESPN app.
Swamp was rocking last Saturday night for that game,
man.
Now.
They out-physical Tennessee for four quarters.
They didn't back down.
Well done. McCall. Shot. Touchdown. Open. Touchdown. Coastal. Jamison Tucker. You wanted to draw up a first possession for Tim Beck out of the locker room? That was perfect. 27 yards later, extra point away from 17-10.
And you talk about setting up the run game opens up play action. You just see right here a little double move. The corner squeezes on the inside guy. He thought the outside guy was just going to run a hitch and stay there. That's a blown coverage on the back end. For as good as this secondary's played, that was the first big mistake we've seen.
And that was leaving number 5, Brykeys Brown, in an awful position. And how about McCall? With that touchdown pass, goes over 10,000 yards for his career.
And that's unbelievable to put up those numbers. But as you'll see right here, the run game has helped set this up. They max protect, little play action pass, protecting with 7 guys. But you see the corner to the field, they're in a one high defense. He's got to keep his width. He squeezed the inside receiver up the seam, loses the hitch and go by the outside gap receiver. easy throw and catch for Grayson McCall. You know, that's not, you don't want to give him easy throws and let him get in a rhythm.
And the point that you made there, when we came out on camera to start the third quarter, you said they have to run the ball, they have to run the ball. They get into that two-back set, they were popping for 12, they were popping for 13. They got that running game open, which opened up the offense for McCall to do that.
And that's what you say. When you're a coach, you're looking at things in the game sometimes saying, hey, we're down two scores in the second half. We're really struggling to run the ball. Let's not abandon it. Let's do what we do well, because if we can establish it, especially in this first drive, it's going to put us right back into this game.
So it is 17-10 now. Granger and the Panthers will get the ball for the first time in the third quarter. They were very effective in the first half. Tyleek Williams deep to receive the Liam Gray kick. Touchback. And if you're Granger and Georgia State, you had success in the first half. 229 total yards, pretty evenly distributed between rush and pass. Game plan third quarter is what?
Well, I think a lot more of the same, because Granger's done a great job managing this game. They've brought a lot of different pressure and looks off of them. They've been able to create some advantage numbers in the run game, and he's taken advantage of it. And when he's gotten one-on-one man coverage on the outside, he's made the throws and made the right decisions.
Ball at the 25. Granger. Option. Pitch. Good read. Good run. First down, Panthers. Marcus Carroll. That was executed well. And a gain of 14 brought down by Braylon Ryan.
And it looked like Coastal had this defended with two guys out there. But great patience by Granger. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Keep stretching the defense. Attack the pitch key. Make the pitch late.
They're going to run it again with Granger. That's a tough 4 yards by the quarterback. Fletcher, who was kind of left behind on the option play before, brings him down. Fletcher last week, a 100-yard pick six. And this defense gave up a couple of scores, but they've been able to slow down Georgia State spots.
And keep them in the game when they needed to.
Quick shot at the outside. There was no one over there for Coastal. That'll be a first down. That's easy work from Carroll. Lusk brings him down after a gain of 9.
And these little quick completions allow them to pick up the pace on the offense and continue the tempo and put their foot on the gas against this Coastal Carolina defense. Not let them get the calls in or substitute.
Back in Chanticleer's territory. Granger looks to take a shot, goes deep down the field, has a receiver, almost a one-handed grab by Tyleek Williams. Juan Powell was there, but what an effort out of Williams. Couldn't come down with it. Good coverage. That was just good football by both
sides. That's great football right there. Great protection up front. Great job by Granger. Patience in the pocket. Look at the DBs going, battling for the ball. I don't see much there in a PI. I think that's just great football by everybody. I mean, from the O-line, the quarterback, the receivers, the DB. That's good football.
Hats off to the officials. Let them play. Matt Austin, that includes you. Granger to keep it. And there was that option look again. Coastal was able to string it out. Had the pitch man handled. Granger kept it for one. JT Killen, first man there.
And this is the defense we're expecting to see from Coastal. Guys fly into the football, stopping the run, putting them into a third down situation. See, they come with a mass substitution, get their nickel package onto the field right here, get some pass rushers ready to go make the play, try to get off the field on third down.
So after Coastal marched down the field and scored, this would be a big change in momentum. Third and 9. Granger out of the pocket. Escapes the sack. Granger's got space, and he'll get the first down. That is Darren Granger in a nutshell. You think you've got him bottled up by Michael Mason? He finds his way out of the pocket, and he gets 11.
Yeah, that's just a great individual effort. They bring the pressure, keeps eyes downfield, slides in the pocket, breaks the tackle, realizes in trouble, gets out, knows where the first down maker. Watch it, the little move at the end to get by Shane Bruce, the leader of this defense for Coastal Carolina, to get the first down yardage necessary. Great individual effort by Granger.
By the way, that first down pylon's got my football hormones raging. Have you seen that thing?
That's awesome.
That's amazing. By the way,
we got it all going here on Thursday night, but we have the new technology.
Listen,
It's interesting. We had Charlie Ward on. We had Heisman Trophy winners. We have beautiful golf swing.
I'm missing
major tons. Champions.
8 of 11 on third downs. That was a look at the first down count, by the way. Second and 7. His ability to extend plays is something else.
It's not just that, the confidence in the pocket. You see him right there.
That is Robert Lewis for 14.
And you look how calm Granger's eyes down the field with all that pressure. Scanning the field, eyes down the field. No worries. I'm just going to drop the ball in, move the chains, get a first down.
Quick outside again. Jakari Carter. Flag on the play.
So it's actually a big hold or a block in the back right here on the edge.
Again, so many storylines coming into this game with these two programs. Very similar. Still new in their development in FBS. 2013 to 2017. Sean Elliott after a season last year.
10-yard penalty.
4-8.
From the end of the run.
Went back to the drawing board. I'm just going to step on his mic. Gets two in and out.
Yeah, he's struggling
tonight.
Here's
what we're
going
to do at home
right
tonight. You just got to know what the signals are at home. That's a hold. But look, 4-8 last year. He told us, like, man, we were in a dark spot. And even I had to reassess. And so they went to work this offseason. On the other side, Tim Beck comes in. You made a perfect point, Tim, in our meeting with Beck yesterday. This is a hard job to come to because it was successful when Jamie Chadwell left.
Always hard to take over a program that's been winning and say, hey, I'm going to implement how we're going to do things here in the future when the players have been successful. And that's such a big challenge. And, you know, one of the things Tim Beck brought and had talked about within doing this with for those players was, let's look forward. I know you've been successful here, but the focus is going to be moving forward. We're going to be a little bit mentally tough. We're going to build some maturity. Even in his first team meeting, he said, you guys aren't ready to listen to me yet.
Because he knew they were angry.
They were angry. Their coach left. There was a lot going on. Met with everybody individual and said, hey, I know we've been successful, but let's focus on how we can even get better and look to the future.
And that's Carroll off the inside. And a gain of 5, Will Whitston on the tackle. Carroll over 100 yards on the night. Yeah, I thought that was interesting. During the coaching conversation, Beck went in front of the team and he goes, you guys aren't ready to listen.
Yeah.
And I get it. I get it.
It's such a hard challenge as a coach when you come in and you're taking over a program that's won because the players said, hey, we've been successful.
Yeah,
you're telling me all these new things to do.
Yeah.
We just got left. You know, we know what works. And I think Tim and his staff's done a great job.
There's that bunch formation, bottom of the screen, 3rd and 9.
He's got 3 different options right here, run, screen, or one-on-one pass.
And he's looked at the one-on-one. That's a designed run by Granger. Great play call. Ball comes out.
Still loose.
I think Georgia State fell on it. There was more blue there than white at the end. Was that Avery Reese?
There's a big guys in this scrum at the bottom.
And now we're getting chippy.
Oh, the chippiness starts. Just need to get everybody out of there.
Yeah, it was
but we're playing some physical good football.
Avery Reese, the center. He snapped it. He recovered it. Have another look at the ball popping out.
He's just got to keep that ball tight. I mean, you know when you're going to run that hit. Hits are going to come from everywhere as a quarterback. You just got to keep that ball high and tight.
Good play call was on there. Designed run. Bruce forced the fumble. 38-yard attempt by Leon Rickman. I tell you, we haven't had a college kicker situation yet.
No, it's like making it easy out here right there.
Rickman, just a chip shot. So Georgia State answers with a field goal. 20 to 10. It's over 5 minutes left in the third.
Trick or treat! Kick yeah. Reese's!
Oh, great costume. Looks like you deserve both.
See ya, boys.
Man, I wish I was out there.
Let's unretire.
Why not?
Dan Marino?
You're all right?
22. 22.
I'm good right here, bro.
Should we?
Don't even think about it.
Interesting piece. Let me bring in my expert.
So many scratches.
Those are from my car keys.
Such a rich history. This won't do well at auction. But at AT&T, it's worth a brand new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 5.
Wait, really?
Mm-hmm.
What about this?
AT&T's deal is back.
Wow.
Everyone gets a free new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 5 with a Galaxy phone trade-in. Any year, any condition.
Where'd you learn to serve?
Oh, I didn't serve. But if your spouse, parent, or grandparent served in the military, you can join USAA.
Yeah, my grandpa did. So I'm already in. But I was talking about your serve.
Oh.
USAA. For the military community.
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing. Now they are a thing. And eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America. Arby's, we have the meat.
New Dove Men Body Wash gives you 24 hours of nourishing micro-moisture. That means your skin still feels healthy and smooth now, now, and now too. Get healthier, smoother feeling skin all day.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
Hmm.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
Hmm.
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 So JJ's for lunch?
The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid. Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both.
Football is back. Got your new fantasy team name? Check. Grill? Check. Fancy grill? Check. Troy and Joe? Check. Bro and bro? Check. All the emotions? All season long? Check, baby.
You want to see a nightmare running on the field? Like, what is this?
I'm not sure.
Do we
it's
know?
Racing, it's racing the rooster, the Chanticleer rooster, and it's...
Did he come dressed like that?
Or it is a whiteout tonight.
Can you imagine that standing over you while you're sleeping?
That's the student of the game here.
Oh.
It's not just college, it's coastal here.
Understood. I still have no idea what the hell that is. Georgia State brought the pack tonight. Big game to see Darren Granger. By the way, Granger told us from Conway, South Carolina, this is a home game for him and a homecoming. He said he had 26-plus ticket requests. Come see one of the local heroes in this area. Granger right now has his guys up 20-10. 3-0 for the first time in program history. On the road. Sun Belt opener. Sun Belt East, tough. JMU involved in this one. Isaac Cohn to kick. Touchback. I know. We're sorry. More football after the break. I promise.
A truck is a tool, but a ram is life. It's the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
Okay, again, this is a status bar, this is a search bar. Let's know the difference, okay?
Social media. It can be overwhelming for a young homeowner turning into their parents.
Now, what does it mean to slide into someone's DMs? That sounds like a lot of fun.
Okay, we're not ready for that.
As a team, we'll get there.
It might be a fruit emoji, but that doesn't mean they're talking about fruit.
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home and auto with us.
Okay, do you really think we need 47 photos of fun dinner at Pam's?
Yes.
No.
On season 6 of Fansville, it's the last year of college football as we know it.
What's going on?
The road to the playoff is expanding.
To 12 lanes.
Rivalries are crumbling.
Why are you leaving?
TV revenue. You wouldn't understand.
So we're just not rivals anymore?
Tensions are rising.
Where's the flag?
These refs should be criminally investigated. Do something!
Because this season, things are heating up.
What's happening, Sheriff?
It's a transfer portal. It's out of control.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
I wish for the amazing new iPhone 15 Pro.
Sean! Do you mean this one, the one with titanium?
No way I could trade this busted up thing for one.
Maybe stealing wishes from the birthday boy is not your best plan. Switch to Verizon and trade in any iPhone and get the new iPhone 15 Pro on them.
What?
Yep, and on an amazing network.
And I don't have to ruin any more birthday parties.
Yeah, that ship has sailed. Let's go get you that iPhone. Here we go. Come on now.
Trade in any iPhone in any condition for a new iPhone 15 Pro on us, only on Verizon.
How do they make Starburst taste so juicy?
I don't know, but you just asked the whole universe.
Humans are asking for juice.
And we are the juice.
Starburst, unexplainably juicy.
Did you see that? Yep, looks like rain. Also looks like McDelivery. Order McDelivery in the app.
I want to dominate.
It ain't no regular game.
Big time Pac-12 game. Can't wait to see how good both these teams are.
Colorado, Oregon, Saturday on ABC.
Two of the top games to kick off your Saturday, ABC and the ESPN app. How about the Pac-12 for the first time in history? Three ranked matchups.
Over 100 years.
Three ranked matchups on one Saturday.
History of the conference.
Those are all the ranked teams. By my count, that's eight.
Best conference in college football.
No right question, now. But let's blow it up. I have an idea.
Yeah,
let's
it's
have
too
eight
good.
Teams.
It's too good, Matt. We can't do it.
Three Heisman Trophy finalists, three in the top 10. You know what? Let's send USC to Rutgers.
First and 10 on Coastal Carolina.
There's an offside on the kick. So the ball now goes to the 30. That'll conclude my Pac-12 soapbox. A call to throw. Had some success last drive. Quick shot to the outside. Brown falls. And that probably, for me, one of the biggest surprises of tonight. They haven't been able to get Jared Brown going like they wanted to. Emphasis in getting the ball in his hands.
And they haven't, but, you know, it's really, Grayson McCall has just been off a little bit. And, you know, what we expect to see him usually so accurate. Yeah, he's a very good decision maker, but he's just been off a little bit with his throws.
Curious, though, to abandon the run. Last possession, they had the two setback. Now there's one, second and 10. Had the running game going on the last drive. And they try to stick it up there with the one back, and it's nothing doing. 1 yard. Baltazar, the carrier, now third and long.
And coming off the last drive, this is, you know, you want to come out. You want to.
Is number 74.
That's a trick they just made some.
95, now 74. What's the difference between 95 and 74? It's still a line number. I mean, like 95 to 2, I get.
That's different. Yeah,
but that guy's,
off right
that, a guy that wears 95 is not athletic enough to wear 2.
Ripped or torn jersey. That's good.
Third and 9. Pressure. Picked up well. McCall given time. He can run or throw. He decides to throw. That's Tyson Mobley. Mobley some yak. And a great job picking up the blitz by Coastal Carolina. Gain of 26. McCall could have run for it, but he chose Mobley. That's a big game.
Yeah, I think a great decision by McCall to do that right there. You're going to run for it. The safeties are going to close in. I think you're going to get close to the first down mark. But get the ball out on the edge. Look at our awesome first down cam.
There it is.
Right there to see that catch. And then Mobley looks like he's going to go out of bounds, extends the play, makes someone miss. Big play, and they're back in business. Back to this two-back set that they had success with in the last series.
2 for 59 for Mobley. Back in Georgia State territory. They've been using that two-back, as you said, and it's gotten positive yardage every time they've run out of that formation. Baltazar picks up 7.
And they're just running the same play. They're running the split back inside zone. with the one, the back coming across the formation to block the backside edge and hand it off inside zone.
Quickly to Harry. Guys, these running backs on the Coastal Carolina sideline before they got back here on the field were itching to get back out here. You're seeing that in these runs right here.
Yeah, and we mentioned it, Harry, the two-back set for back in this offense has been successful as the play clock down to 10. McCall switched the play. Bennett, Baltazar in the backfield. How about it again? There goes Bennett. Tygee Leach after 15. Coach, I don't know why they go.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it right there. All it is inside zone. And you just see right there, Baltazar come back, block the backside C gap, hand the ball off to Bennett.
Is it because they have to account for another player out of the backfield?
What it is right now when you're in the split back set, you can run the play in either direction. Here's going to be a trick play, it looks like. All right, there's a tight end eligible up top of the screen right there. They weren't falling for the banana in the tailpipe right there.
McCall's is good. Oh! I mean, that is Jake the Snake type stuff. McCall to Mobley. Now, 62 was dropped down to the bottom of the screen. He had me thinking we were going to get a thick six. 62. Don't tell me 62 is a decoy.
But if you see it right now, they try to do this. They spread everybody out to hide, but they're hiding. That's the tight end. They're trying to play him at the offensive line. They're hiding him in the formation.
I think they're going to call him over the line of scrimmage. Yeah.
Number 66. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay. First down.
We got all excited for nothing.
But if they had the play set up, Georgia State defended it perfectly right there within the trick play, trying to get it, disguise it, sneak the tight end down the middle of the field.
So Matt Austin, let's bring you in for the first time tonight. It looked as if the setup was there, but apparently the guy was not.
Yeah, I couldn't hear the announcement of the official, so ineligible receiver. I don't know if he was... I'm not sure what they called. You need to have 550 and 79 on the line. 62 came down below. He can be a decoy. He can catch a backwards pass, but he can't catch a forward pass.
They called 66 on it. There's Brown making a couple of men miss after the rollout right. Abraham, the first guy there, gain of 5. And so another penalty. Yeah, have another look at this, Coach.
Yeah, so as they shift out right now, you know, this is a big... Gus Malzahn and Auburn used to do this all the time. He's trying to sneak the tight end down the middle of the field. You saw they locked down. They covered him. He came open late. But it's the lineman drifting downfield. Can't happen.
Left guard got
left
a little
guard,
bit of...
They got overzealous. A little excited.
Yeah. He's like, one of my own's going to score a touchdown. So now second and 10. Brown got 5. The penalty yard is back. Trying to run it back up there again. A good physical running by Bennett. Leach and Pringle there. Gain of 6. Third and medium, helmet off. Under a minute in the third quarter.
Pringle a little bit shaken up right there coming in to try to make the tackle off the edge. The physical running by Braden Bennett. And that's, we talked about it at halftime. If they can establish the run, that's what's going to get them back into this game.
Okay, under a minute left here in the third. They're going to look at Pringle. We'll be back. Coastal driving.
The moment is here. The MLB Wildcard Series on the networks of ESPN.
I don't know Jake from State Farm.
But just imagine. My homes and my auto.
Best bundle in the league, baby.
Man, why can't Patrick change his name? It could be Kelsey and Kelsey, how much you can save by bundling home and auto. Yeah? If you make the letters smaller.
My homes, my auto, let's go!
Come on, model, let's get it. Put your jersey on.
Bundling.
On.
Just another way to save with a personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
At the Cracker Barrel. Freshly made food at a fair price is just what we do. In fact, we've got over 20 meals under $12. Each served with a helping of care. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
If you have heart disease and are on a statin, lowering cholesterol can be hard. Diets and exercise add to the struggle. Today, it's possible to go from struggle to cholesterol success with Leqvio. With a statin, Leqvio is proven to lower bad cholesterol by over 50% and keep it low with 2 doses a year. Common side effects were injection site reaction, joint pain, urinary tract infection, diarrhea, chest cold, pain in legs or arms, and shortness of breath. Ask your doctor about twice yearly Leqvio. Lower, longer Leqvio.
Okay, get this right, and you get my free ticket to tonight's game. Who is my all-time favorite receiver?
Larry Fitzgerald.
Yes, Larry Fitzgerald.
Hey, I heard you got an extra ticket to the game tonight. I would love to go.
Yeah, sure. It's all yours, Larry.
Thanks, Billy. I'll meet you out front.
What?
Yeah, okay. It's Bob, but okay. Yeah.
He doesn't even know your name, dude.
I guess I'm Bill now.
With Vivid Seats, when you buy 10 tickets, you can get your 11th free.
Cheese crackers, Sargento. Yum, 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 yum. Perfectly sized cheese and Ritz, cheese and Triscuit, cheese and Wheat Thins. Cheese, real natural cheese. Now with your favorite crackers.
Sargento.
We're real cheese people.
Aww. Okay, let's scamper along. Wow, it's a whole herd. Well, you know what? More time for me to spend in my new Tundra. And a turtle. Guess it's time to catch up on my reading.
Cherish your time in any new Toyota. Get 3.99% financing for 48 months on Camry, Highlander, RAV4, and Tacoma. Toyota, let's go places.
With Chevy Silverado and Silverado HD, you can take on the mountains. Or you can move them. With the power of up to 36,000 pounds of max available towing and the confidence of an available 13.4-inch diagonal touchscreen. Whatever your mountain, there's a Silverado for you. Get 0% financing on all 2023 Silverado 1500 pickups plus. Make no monthly payments for 90 days. Or get $5,000 total value on this Silverado with a Turbo Max engine. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Great NFL lineup for you this weekend. Kick off your Sunday NFL countdown, 10 Eastern. A look at 7 years of Jets frustrations leading up to their matchup against the Pats. Plus updates and developing news. Then on Monday, two games on ABC, ESPN, and the app. 7 Eastern, Eagles play the Buccaneers. Then at 8, the Bengals host the Rams. Only thing better than one Monday Night Football game
is two.
There you go.
I love my Sunday countdown. I love my guy Alex Smith doing a heck of a job. New guy on that show right there.
Yeah, old Dan Mullen.
Love watching Alex. He knows some ball now.
Dan Mullen calling ball plays got Alex Smith to be the number one overall pick for the San Francisco 49ers.
Love doubleheaders on Monday night, too.
It is good. Just brings that degenerate out in all of us. Third and five. McCall down the sideline. Wheel route, no. Not sure how that was executed. Wouldn't have been caught anyway.
Great coverage right there. And so I think, you know, you're looking at McCall. Great coverage on it. He's not going to make a mistake. They're in the red zone. They're in a scoring situation. He threw it away right there. Taji Leach on the coverage and had the back, the wheel route locked down the sideline. And you see, Grayson was pleading to go for it on fourth down, though.
34-yard attempt from Liam Gray to keep this a one-score game. And they've been playing that way. They've been playing points and field position. Liam Gray, no good. Gray hooked it.
And you just jinxed our college kicker situation earlier.
I did. Oh, the flag guy thinks they made it.
Oh, that's a dollar.
That is a dollar.
That is a dollar.
No one told him. And Sean Elliott, again, fired up. That's the second missed field goal of the night. Now, to be fair, the one earlier was 51 yards. But Liam Gray does not come through for back in the offense. And we talked about you bringing up Alex Smith and the 6 degrees of Dan Mullen. Our goal this year is to find a connection that you have with everyone that we play and coach against. And what is your 6 degrees of separation this week?
Well, you come in with Tim Beck, who's obviously a great offensive coordinator in his time, great quarterback coach. He was with my good friend Dave Dorn before he came here at NC State. But we both have a lot in common, and that was being the quarterback coach, offensive coordinator for Urban Meyer.
And how about that? A big play out of the backfield from Marcus Carroll to get it started. 28 yards. There was some separation there from Georgia State on the Coastal defense.
Great answer. Explosive play coming off the missed field goal, creating that momentum. I'll tell you what, though, that's the 6 degrees of separation right here. there's going to be some more to talk about in this, because in this game with the rest of this crew, there are a lot more connections than just being the quarterback, coach, offensive coordinator, sharing those stories. For doing that for Urban Meyer, I did it at Bowling Green, Utah, and Florida, and Tim Beck did it obviously at Ohio State.
Elliott is fired up, by the way.
He's juiced up. He's a line coach. Hey, you know, those guys, even when they do the interviews, you hear him talk. He's a line coach.
3-0 for the first time in program history. Looking to move 4-0. Fourth quarter coming up from Conway. Georgia State leads 20-10.
Colorado, Oregon. Saturday on ABC.
Those new tiles are falling right into place until you run out of... What are those called again? Oh, right. The Home Depot app is made for doing that doesn't miss a beat. So you can find what you need fast and keep things moving in the right direction. For doing that doesn't stop, download the Home Depot app. It's made for doing.
Right now at Ashley, pay 0% interest for 5 years on top mattress brands like Tempur-Pedic starting at $37 per month, Purple starting at $39 per month, and learn how to save up to $300 on your furniture purchase only at Ashley.
Sure, there's food at home. But is there a McDouble with extra pickles, a side of fries, and a high C at home? Don't be ridiculous.
Booking.com. I'm going to somewhere, anywhere. A beach house, a tree house. Honestly, I don't care. Hello, humidity.
A fancy hotel with a sexy garden.
Landscape architect.
A tiny home with aggressive flair. Somewhere, anywhere. As long as they have childcare.
Booking.com. Booking.
Yeah.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
Hmm.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
So JJ's for lunch?
The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid. Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both.
Series. Struck out with the cheap seats? Important things aren't worth compromising. At Farmers, we offer both quality insurance and great savings. Here, take mine.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
You know why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat.
Every year, thousands of athletes disappear in clutch moments due to falling hydration levels.
I used to go missing all the time. I let everyone down. I even let Shannon Sharp down.
You let me down.
They've been told how you feel yourself doesn't matter, that electrolytes are all the same. And just like that, they're gone. Get yourself back in the game. Get yourself a Gatorade. Could be the difference between dominating and disappearing. Gatorade, rehydrate, replenish, refuel.
I've always loved building things. Not just structures and skyscrapers, but teams who make it all possible. After all, we wouldn't be where we are today without them. So we made sure that, like these buildings, their futures may also stand the test of time.
I'm not the only one with connections to Tim Beck when we look at our 6 degrees of separation. Early in his career over at Swirl High School in Scottsdale, he coached a team. He was telling us they were known as the Raiders of high school football.
The Bad Boys of Scottsdale, baby.
Led by one Matt Berry.
Look at that guy.
Look at that. That is pure intimidation right there coming at you. The shoulder pads.
Granger. Flag and a catch. What a... No, fell incomplete. That is my fault. Falls incomplete. Rolled on the turf. It will be a flag. I got fired up about the Bad Boys of Scottsdale. I was going to give him a reception.
But that
intended for Lewis. It looked like it got pass trapped in there and falls defense to the turf.
Yeah, just a second early on the grab. Got
automatic first down.
Great shot, though. Real accurate with Granger getting down the field to give his receiver a chance. I'll tell you what, that Matt Berry in that number 11 jersey wouldn't have let that happen. He would have been imposing his will. The face, that look. That's like the, isn't that like picture down? You're supposed to smile?
I was 195 pounds of bad intentions then. 1996. That was a lot of creatine and anger.
How'd you guys do that year?
We won the state championship. Large part in thanks to Mike Brown. One of the greatest players I've ever seen.
And a smart coach at Tim Beck. Just give him the ball and get out of the way, right?
Tim Beck started his head coaching career there in Scottsdale, Saguaro. He was 27 years old.
Yeah.
When he got that job.
Having to deal with guys like you.
Yeah. We had a great time. We were in his office yesterday for over and had a great time reminiscing about the good old days. And it really is good to see him get this opportunity as Granger to Ty Leek Williams. And Ty Leek, all speed, JT killing. And I tell you what, Georgia State now is putting the pressure on Coastal, up 20-10 here early in the fourth quarter with tempo.
Yeah, and they do it. Get right back in the ball. And this is where they're dangerous. This is where all the RPOs come. And Granger has the ability to run the football from these empty sets.
And there he does. Not much going for Granger on first down. Down to Harry.
Guys, Kevin Swint told us earlier in the week, they're preaching start fast and finish strong. Getting in the end zone right here would go a long way in accomplishing that.
Yeah, and look, they did that. They did that. They talked to us about that Stone Mountain journey they had in the offseason, where it was a moment for them to work, come to clarity, come together, learn how to finish what they started. And after the 4-8 season, that wasn't good enough for them. Looks like we've got motion. No flag. There's the flag. So a free play falls incomplete.
The flag came in late right there, it looked like.
Came from the far side.
They got him.
Offside, defense, number 21. 5-yard penalty results in the first down.
So that was killing. A second down.
Create the first and goal situation here.
I mean, this is big for this Georgia State offense. Touchdown here makes it 27-10. I know there's a whole fourth quarter to play, but they've been tough on both sides.
The inbounds, they got four receivers into the short side of the field. There's a lot of field out here to the wide side.
They run it right up the middle, and he drops into the end zone. That was easy work for Marcus Carroll. He was untouched. And what an answer for the Panthers.
And you see, when you put the four receivers into the boundary, it gets the defense out of their comfort zone. And all of a sudden, they motion the tight end in. And what they're doing is they're motioning the tight end into almost an offensive line position in the middle of the line. And it's creating an extra gap on the defense. And that's where they're running the ball and attacking that front of the Chanticleers.
And Georgia State comes on the road in the Sun Belt opener, and they are rolling. 27-10, five plays, 80 yards, and Marcus Carroll. Panthers are on the prowl. Fourth quarter.
Your dog is the one you wanted. You want what's best for them. So, ask your vet about new NexGard Plus. It's one-and-done monthly protection from fleas and ticks, plus heartworm disease, roundworms, and hookworms, all in a delicious, beef-flavored soft chew. Use with caution in dogs with a history of seizures or neurologic disorders. From the maker of number one vet-recommended HeartGard Plus, NexGard Plus, the one you want for one-and-done protection.
Oh, hi!
You're in a hurry.
I'm off to America's Best. I heard what you said about not overpaying for glasses.
Two pairs and a free quality eye exam starting at just $79.95?
Yes! The exam alone is worth
$59.
Which is great, because I hate getting overcharged.
You have no idea.
I mean, people deserve breaks, right?
Yeah, breaks.
Let's go save. Can't stop, won't stop.
Coming in hot. Two pairs and a free exam starting at $79.95. Book an exam today at americasbest.com. Do I just leave it here?
There's never a dull moment for the Nelsons. Fifth-generation Montana ranchers. There's a story in every piece of land. Run with us on a John Deere Gator XUV and start telling yours.
It's a good day to start something new. To brush away gray in 5 easy minutes. To put yourself out there and always put your best face forward. Just for men, mustache, and beard.
The Little League World Series champions!
Okay, let's scamper along. Wow, it's a whole herd. Well, you know what? More time for me to spend in my new Tundra. And a turtle. Guess it's time to catch up on my reading.
Cherish your time in any new Toyota. Get 3.99% financing for 48 months on Camry, Highlander, RAV4, and Tacoma. Toyota, let's go places.
Are you on your way?
Yep, coming.
And Mom and Dad?
Don't worry, they'll be there.
Happy anniversary!
Go beyond the expected with the number one most dependable mass market brand 3 years in a row by J.D. Power. Kia, movement that inspires.
Two of the top games to kick off your Saturday, ABC and the ESPN app. Number 4, Florida State travels to Death Valley to take on Clemson, noon Eastern, then Coach Prime. Number 19, Colorado takes on number 10, Oregon, ABC.
There'll be some points in that one.
The wrap-up, college football final, myself, Dan Mullen, Joey Galloway, every Saturday. If I know our producers of college football final, Jeff Brown, well, we will be leading with Colorado, Oregon. Provided any major upset. But my guess is that's the lead in the clubhouse as we take a look now at this week's college football rankings brought to you by Prudential. And same as it ever was, Georgia, Michigan, Texas moves up to 3. But I'm going to tell you something about Florida State, USC, Ohio State. We're going to learn a lot about the Buckeyes this weekend against Notre Dame. I love Florida State going to Clemson. If they get by the tie, you have to look at Florida State as a legitimate national championship contender.
With a win on the road at Clemson, that certainly puts them right in the discussion. They'll be favored the rest of the way after that, I think. They'll have a tough game against Florida, who look pretty good at the end of the season. But they're going to look like contenders so far this year. Even a little, not great last week, but they still found a way to win.
Just don't know enough about Georgia. A call back to work, quick shot to his tight end, Kendall Carr. That'll be a first down for Coastal. The gain of 12. Tyge Leach.
This is a big drive here for Coastal. Even down 3 scores, you got to get the first before you can get the second. So just run our stuff. Let's put a good drive together here and get the ball in the end zone.
McCall quickly out of the backfield. Beasley. Beasley bounces off a tackler, and he's going to get a first down. Good hard running by Beasley. Leach again brings him down, gain of 14.
And that type of play right there lets you get back on the ball, lets you keep going and move the chains, keep the tempo going. Great job, McCall. Like we said, you don't need it all at once. You're a veteran guy. Check it down. We're just going to move the ball down the field. We don't have to rush. Let's just get the first score and then go from there.
And that's it. The crazy things happen in college football.
Especially on Thursday night.
That's right. McCall sets his feet. Quick out route, good run, good route. Tyson Mobley, short of the first down, gain of 9. You get this 27-17, who knows?
This is what we expect and what we've come to see from McCall through the years. A guy calm in the pocket, accurate, makes the throws, great decision maker.
Thank you.
So second and one, playbook pretty much open here. Already in Georgia State territory. Quick handoff to the inside, and that's going to be a first down. That's Baltazar. Second half, running's been good for the Chanticleers. Brought down after 7 yards. Jordan Benzial.
Been in a much better flow this second half. Running the ball, throwing the ball. They haven't missed a field goal in the last drive, which really hurt you. They haven't been able to finish drives in the red zone.
First time out.
So Georgia State sees the tempo. They bang a timeout. Just 6 yards rushing for the Chanticleers in the first half. Now 97, moving the ball. 27-10, early fourth quarter.
Hey, used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the fenders, I'm a diamond in the rough. Hey, first order of biz, no snitching. I try to keep it silent, but the kids don't listen.
Happy birthday,
got another hit, no flinching. I tell them, send a watch that I can fit both wrists. And we used to have a silver tooth, but I was just a pup. Wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the fenders, I'm a diamond in the rough. Hey.
People, it's Reese's season.
Boo.
Go save him. His goat done took over our office.
And he's using it to send out medical bills.
Good hands.
Hospital bill for Prime.
Yeah.
Did you just say get?
He's talking about expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Good thing Coach Prime knows about saying one time.
Aflac.
Because Aflac gets you money to help close that gap.
Now how do we get this goat out of here?
Aflac.
Meet one of my new homies.
Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Aflac
is an official sponsor of ESPN College Game Day.
Elephant would have been scarier.
There are some things that go better together.
Burger and fries.
Soup and salad.
Like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. With Voya, considering all your financial choices together can help you make smarter decisions.
Voya, well planned, well invested, well protected.
When your family is growing in ways you never expected,
so you'd like to be outside the city.
Agents who are Realtors are here for it. Here for the journey. Here with local knowledge beyond the listing. Here for it all, because that's who we are.
On a devastating Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
Whoa! That was past interference!
That's it! Season's over.
Our program's cursed! See?
I can't watch this.
Every year I fall for the preseason hype!
I made all this for nothing!
Never watching football again.
Hey, guys, that was the first play of the game.
Oh, maybe we overreacted.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
Full-time fans, your devotion always delivers. And you deserve a reward. Modelo, the mark of a fighter.
ESPN Thursday Night College Football is brought to you by Taco Bell.
First down, pylon cam, new technology, and all kinds of fun. Different angles, all angles of college football, Thursday, Fridays, and Saturdays. So now Grayson McCall trying to get this thing to two scores, 27. Even a field goal here makes it two scores. You got to get
the momentum. They really, you want to get a touchdown on this drive with momentum. The field goal, they missed the last one. They don't have success scoring in the red zone.
To this point, two missed field goals, 6 points left on the board, one of them from 51. Good kick, just short. First and 10, McCall's got a guy in the backfield if he wants it. Intended for Mobley, incomplete, covered by Brown.
You just see McCall after the throw, not happy with himself right there. He's just been off a little bit tonight with his accuracy. And you can see it. I think he's frustrated with himself. He's a veteran player. He knows it. These guys shake it off, come back. This is one thing he'll do is he'll come back and play the next play.
18 to 28, 214 and a touchdown. Sacked once. Second and 10. Good job picking up the pressure. That goes downfield, and that was a good completion. Pinckney, quiet tonight. Tackled by Pringle.
Well, that's what you talk about there with McCall. Even being a little frustrated at times, he comes back right on rhythm, right on time, hits Pickney right out of the break.
So it's going to bring up third and short. And that's a run right up the middle to get the first down. It was close. Baltazar. And they're moving the chains. Yeah, they were. They're slow to do it.
Yep.
What are they calling here? There we go.
It looked like he was holding up that fourth down at first, and I think that kind of slowed everybody down.
We're sitting there watching the far side. We're thinking
it looked like a first, and he kind of held up the fourth down sign. And
so Baltazar, skin of the lace, first and 10 Coastal.
Watch a shot here.
He's going up top. His receiver, kind of some hand checking. Oh!
What a catch.
That was amazing. Tyson Mobley. Gain of 19. How about that? SportsCenter editors, go ahead and throw that on top 10.
Let's see. I mean, great catch with his hands. He's in.
That the previous play is on the further video.
That's Baryshnikov.
Mobley's been the big play guy for them tonight. We expected the other big name guys with Jared Brown and Pinkney to be, but Mobley's been the big play guy for them tonight. What a fabulous footwork there.
I mean, good coverage, good catch. Have a look at his heel. That's what we're watching. Oh, Matt Austin, our rules analyst with us again this evening.
That looks like a classic toe heel, which makes that an incomplete pass. If he drags his toe, he's good. If the heel comes down as part of the natural movement and it's out of bounds, it's an incomplete pass. So I think this is going to be overturned.
Still a great catch.
Fantastic.
It's not going to go on the stat sheet, but just the effort there to go up and get it. Millimeters from being in bounds. But I'm with Austin. That'll get overturned.
Mobley's had a great night tonight.
Yeah, he's been the go-to guy. We talked about Jared Brown coming in. We talked about Sam Pinckney coming in. That's the view where you can see clearly.
Just see the heel.
Yeah.
As you said, Baryshnikov, he needed his point shoes on that one right there, right? To get into ballet terms.
That's something else. But you're a man of the theater, the ballet?
I am a man of the theater. Love the theater.
Really?
Yep. My mom taught classical ballet. Pat teaches classical ballet. I did ballet when I was young.
You did ballet?
Absolutely.
Amazing. Did you really?
Yes. I didn't have the beautiful hair you've had, as we saw, all the way from high school.
Who's a different?
All the way from high school till now. Most people, their hair goes a different direction
sure.
as they got older.
Yeah.
Matt just is a...
I was really
worried. I mean, a style, the hairstyle can go anywhere.
After video review, the ruling on the field is an incomplete pass at the sideline. It'd be second down at the 23-yard line.
Listen, doesn't take away from the effort, because that's a catch with just centimeters.
I mean, that catch was as good as Matt's hair. It was. No, I loved it. I mean, the style when it was young, that was amazing.
It was now. I was really playing the college back then.
Yeah.
All right, second and 10. Ball at the 24. McCall pressured. McCall goes down. How about Anthony Bloom? Second sack of the night for Georgia State. He came untouched and a loss of 8.
And Georgia State's been pressuring all night, and with the lead, a 3-score lead, they're not slowing down right now. You see the twist game coming and confuses the offensive line, and they just let him go clean up the middle. You can't do that. They got to stay with it. Let the twist guy go. Let the free rusher come late.
And if they were,
they let Bloom go right up the middle.
If they were making field goal, that knocked him out. McCall trying to create some separation. Good job getting out of the pocket. And again, that's Mobley. Big hit. Big hit on the sideline. Gain of 14. So now fourth and short. Fourth and four.
Decision time here for Tim Beck. They're down three scores. They need a score. They've been conservative at times going kicking. They're going to go for it here. I think they're down here. They need the touchdown. They're down three scores. They need a touchdown to get back into this game.
All right.
But they also looks like Georgia State's going to come after them again, though.
All right, so it's going to be a timeout. So the shot declares use their first timeout of the half. We'll find out what they do when we come back.
I used to watch the Heisman House every year on TV. And I'd always wonder, is it real? It's very real.
Take a little bit more up the top.
Now that I've been here a while, it's a lot like campus. We have roommates.
Hey, Caleb, just try and keep it down. It's nap time.
Of course there's a gym.
10.
All right, people, here we go. Looking good, RG3.
No, you're looking good, RG3.
Yeah, so it's a lot like...
You need a room, rookie?
We're doing a ticky-tock.
Bam, bam.
Just like campus.
The same thing for anyone, but we're something for everyone. With packing, shipping, printing, and more, we're the one stop right around the corner. Everything you need to make your small business be unstoppable. Store the UPS store.
When football was introduced, Arby's and boneless wings weren't a thing. Now they are a thing, and eating $5 boneless wings with fries is the most popular sport in America.
Arby's, we have the meat.
For all my life, I'll be devoted to you.
You don't have to be there to be there with AT&T 5G.
AI has the power to automate. But if it's using untrusted data, can you trust the results? Your business doesn't just need AI, it needs the right AI for your business.
home, auto, and life insurance, plus banking and credit cards.
I'm in because of my dad. You think that'll finally get you in?
Probably not, but it looks great.
USAA, for the military community and their families.
Perfection.
The fact that this Reese's ad showed up at this exact moment proves that your devices are listening to your stomach.
Introducing KFC's new hot and spicy wings. Spicy marinated and hand-breaded.
Hit it!
Hey, I got more wings!
All right! Get 8 wings for just $4.99.
It's mega-making good!
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and O-Spice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
That looks really high.
It is high.
Whenever you're ready.
Are there any snakes?
Nope.
You sure?
Here we go.
It's time to push your limits.
You're doing great.
Whoa, is that a buffalo?
Babe, that's a cow.
The all-new Subaru Crosstrek Wilderness. Adventure on the edge.
That first time you take a step back and see everything you've accomplished.
I made that.
With your very own online store.
I sold that.
And you can manage it all in one place.
I built this.
And it was easy with GoDaddy.
I am doing this.
With a partner that puts you first. Start for free at GoDaddy.com/sell.
For legal reasons, we can't say an Egg McMuffin is a hangover cure. But it probably wouldn't hurt to have one delivered. Mm. Just putting it out there. Order McDelivery in the app.
Let's do it.
Come on, Dad, get me.
Ooh, nice play.
At Ally, we're helping millions save more for the things that matter most to them. Whatever you're saving for, we're all better off with an Ally.
Get back to work.
Hey. Scott Van Pelt here, getting set for SportsCenter. Get you ready for the rest of week 4 in college football. I lack restraint. We have double-digit winners. Ahead of the weekend in the Pac-12, I think the numbers suggest it could be the biggest weekend that the conference in total's ever had. We got post-game coverage of the Giants and the 49ers when that one goes final. Now back to two men living the dream in Conway. Matt Barry, Dan Mullen, fellas.
Scott Van Pelt knows the good stuff. And we had an onside kick from Coastal Carolina. Spotter to the stars, Dave Salati threw out that as an option during the commercial break.
He did. We
bullied him about it.
We bullied. I thought right there, and believe it or not, Georgia State did not come out with the hands team in that situation where you thought they would. They had their regular return team on the field. They were set up for an excellent kick right here.
I mean, the bounce.
There's the big bounce. But I'll tell you what a play. Who's that coming in?
Benziali. Jordan Benziali.
Jordan Benziali out of nowhere comes flying in to come make the plays. He's an all-state good hands type guy, unlike the last couple plays we've seen.
Early onside kick. 2 timeouts left for Coastal. Still got to play defense, up 27-17. Georgia State also with a pair of timeouts. Play clock down, right up the middle. And a gain of 5 on first down. That was Carroll. So now, Coach Mullen, you go onside kick early. You've got the 2 timeouts. Give me the strategy now on both sides now as we approach 6 minutes 45 seconds.
You want to get off the field. They're still going to try to preserve timeouts for at least one more first down for Coastal Carolina. Georgia State right now, you're going to use the clock. You're just counting the first downs. You're saying, hey, the offense, we're 3 first downs away from ending the game. And so that's a great run on first down. They've got to come back. If we can get three first downs, Ben, put it on the offensive line. Our head coach and O-line coach, let's put the game away with the O-line.
And that's exactly right with Sean Elliott. So that's a timeout after the first down. Remember, new clock rules. That clock's going to still go until it's under 2 minutes.
I think they're holding it. They held it right there. Just the helmet came out. Helmet just came off to stop the clock temporarily.
All right, so now the clock's running.
Yeah.
Good eyes by you. And they will. And look, that the new clock rule, if you're a team trying to salt the clock and win a game, that's
big help right
huge.
Now. Big help right now.
Yards on the ground for the Panthers. And you mentioned it. Sean Elliott, offensive line coach, did that at South Carolina under Steve Spurrier. His son plays football in the Columbia area at AC Flora. This could be the game breaker. And that's another first down by Marcus Carroll. JT Killen missed the tackle. Game the 16, and you talked about we're counting first down.
If you look what they're doing, though, they're putting the tight end in the A-gap. Look at the giant splits on the other side. Trying to create extra gaps for the defense to fit, and it's causing problems, causing confusion with Coastal Carolina. They're getting out of their gaps and having that tight end in, you know, kind of that sniffer A-gap position right there is causing some confusion for the defensive front. Amon Green coming in there, the tight end there. Chris Burns out with an injury, backup tight end coming in and doing a great job blocking in those gaps.
And Carroll came into this game third in FBS with 119.3 yards per game, number one with seven touchdowns. Tonight, 142 yards on 24 carries, only running back to touch the ball for Georgia State tonight. He and Granger have done all the work.
He's been their workhorse all night long. And this team right now, they wanted to show. I think with the, they came out and they said, Coach Elliott came out and said, hey, people might be surprised we're undefeated, but we're not. We have a veteran group. We have guys that have been here and bought into this program for a long time. We have great playmakers on both sides of the ball. They're showing that tonight. They've come here, and there's Coastal Carolina is one of the best home records in college football. And they're going to come in here, and this will be the fourth time in a row they've won in Conway.
And Dave's going to have to call a timeout. Sean Elliott is absolutely furious. They want to roll the play clock down, but they got that to zeros.
The Lair game, Georgia State, 5 yard penalty.
That's going to drive them even more crazy because the 5 yards and not getting the timeout at the end of the play.
So the Elliott we see here is the Elliott we saw pregame. I mean, he's running out now, but this was before the game. You talked about the offensive line coach. This is Elliott in his warm-up gear, just fired up with everybody.
Well, you got the strength coach knocking around. He's knocking players around, make sure everybody's ready to go. He's got a good sweat on. And you can move the O-line coach into the head coach's office, but you can't take the O-line coach out of it.
Quick shot to the outside, Carroll, and that's going to be a late hit.
That's just silly.
That is going to be a late hit on 36, Joey Cash.
Just silly.
It'll be 11 yards plus the flag. You know, and Coastal Carolina gets the momentum off to the touchdown off the punt and special teams. They kick the onside
after the
kick.
Play, personal foul, late hit out of bounds, number 36, defense. Have the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
And in this drive, they've just not been able to make any stops and they shoot themselves in the foot.
But, you know, I mean, this one's just silly here at the end of the play, just like ridiculous. But you look, you got to give Georgia State the credit.
Yeah.
That momentum had just shifted, and all of a sudden there was an onside kick that was there for the taking. They come in and make a special play to recover the onside kick, and then they put the game away. They're putting the game away.
That was, they met at the mess point there. Jaquan Griffin, minus three on that one. And Coastal's going to use one of their timeouts. Second and goal. So So let's take a look at what Carroll has done throughout the night. 27 rushes, 150 yards, two receptions, 36 yards. He's been the tone setter for the Panthers tonight.
And he's been consistent. They've created some different looks and creating extra gaps for him. But I'm telling you, a lot of these runs, most of it's coming on inside zone. He's doing a great job pressing the line of scrimmage, making the reads, getting upfield. And you see him there. Great vision, finding the hole, getting into the end zone. He leads FBS in touchdowns scored this year. You know, this is a complete football team watching Georgia State. They have a great quarterback that can make the reads, extend plays, make things happen on his own. They have some weapons on the outside that can score points. And Marcus Carroll is one of the top backs right now, as you see statistically, in all of college football.
And I'm telling you, this Sun Belt East between James Madison, ODU is having a good season this year. 1-0 in conference, or 1-2 on the year, but they've played some good power fives. Georgia State 3-0, Marshall 2-0, App State 2-1, Coastal 2-1, Georgia Southern. I mean, somebody's just loaded.
It's going to be, I mean, whoever comes out of that division is certainly going to be well deserving. And honestly, and you know, they're going to have an opportunity because of the Sun Belt and the success and the depth of this league. On this side, you never know. They might have an opportunity at a New Year's Six open at the end of the year.
Texas State out of the Sun Belt West beating Baylor early in the season. South Alabama did so against Oklahoma State. This is good football in the Sun Belt. And a big play defensively by Juan Powell. Loss of six.
Timeout. Coastal Carolina. This is the third and final time.
I mean, that was a pile drive.
Please reset the game clock to 3:25. Thank you.
Yeah, and just on the zone read, a great job. When you're in these situations, they've seen it all night long. Does a great job sticking with his assignment, sticking with the quarterback, finishing the tackle right there.
Can I say something that might not sound so obvious? I'm glad that wasn't a play.
Yeah, you see it sometimes, but, you know, he didn't pick him up and slam him. He spun and tackled him, and even though he threw him to the ground. It's when you pick him up and, you know, you go old school WWE.
I was going to say, you go DDP.
Yeah.
Diamond Dallas Page.
That's what it is, you know. I mean, the nature boy would have picked him up and maybe slammed him down. But
Matt Austin.
We are at Myrtle Beach right now. I bet there's some great wrestling matches that have happened around here.
Next week, we're going to Tulsa, home of Bill Goldberg.
Love it.
Goldberg. Can you imagine a golf club in Bill Goldberg's hands? Let's bring out Goldberg for Maddie and Mullen Cup.
I'm going to say he can hit the ball off a tee. If he's a golfer, his tee shot's going to go a little way.
Him holding a golf club would look like him holding a two. And I still want to make him mad. First things first. Back to the game. Third and goal. Ranger keeping an eye on the sideline. Play clock, plenty of time. No rush on the play. Handoff up the middle. And a gain of one.
And they're going to let the clock run all the way down right here.
Now, field goal.
Kick a field goal.
Even makes though, it even 37-0. I mean, it's still a two-score game.
Yeah, but it takes the field. It's two touchdowns and not a touchdown field goal.
Sure.
So, you know, there's going to be a lot of options. They could sit here. You let this clock run all the way down. I think they'll let the clock run down. They'll use one of their timeouts here at Georgia State. And Coach Elliott's going to sit there and discuss it and say, hey, listen, if we do go for it on fourth down, don't be surprised. Going for it on fourth down, they have some great receivers on the outside. We're just going to throw one up in the end zone and see if someone can make a play.
So Coastal's out of timeouts, Georgia State with the one. And Sean Elliott talked to us about finishing games and working hard to finish games. And they did that this offseason at Stone Mountain. And they did this workout. And our Harry Lyles knows it good and well, that area. You live out in that area, Harry. In fact, you're a proud Georgia State alum. What is Stone Mountain all about? Took his breath away.
Yeah. He was He was having nightmares just thinking about having to run up that mountain.
And they
right
said
there.
That's when they came that, together.
The team said that was all the players said it was a mindset change for everybody. They went on this great training session, a team building experience, and it brought them together.
32 yards for Rickman. Okay, so now 30-17. Two touchdown game now for Coastal. They must score twice. 2:36, no timeouts. Quick score, onside kick. But Sean Elliott and his program look like they are going to 4-0 after already making history. That's one thing Elliott told us when we met with him. At a program that's still so new, you can accomplish it first just about every week, just about every month, just about every season.
Absolutely. And they want to build this program. They want to build the program the right way. And I think one of these things, you know, as a coach, they have a certain confidence about them as a coach. And you come into games, you come into seasons, you sit there and say, okay, well, hey, we're not picked as high in the preseason polls, and everybody has questions about us. Last year, we're coming off a tough year, but their schedule last year was really tough early in the season. And he said, people might be surprised we're 3-0, but I'm not, we're not, nobody in our building, nobody on our team is surprised at this. This is what we expected. And they're playing like a team that expects to be a contender.
This is a statement going on the road. And again, one of the crazier stats in all of college football, how the home team has never won in this series in the seven times they've played. I don't know. So Javen Simpkins deep to receive the Isaac Cone kick. And if Grayson McCall has any of that 50-year magic in, and we'll have to see it now. Simpkins gets the ball at his 5, tries to find a crease, gets it by beyond the 25-yard line. Chance Singleton brings him down after a gain of 23.
Well, I'll tell you, if you're in this situation, you got to find a way to score 2 touchdowns in 2 minutes and 30 seconds to win the game. But I'll tell you what, if you want somebody in that situation, it's not bad having a guy like Grayson McCall. You're running out there to try to make it happen.
If you're calling plays, what do you call it?
You're running your 2-minute offense. And Grayson McCall understands that right now. Again, you need 2 scores.
Yep.
You got to get one. I mean, they're not giving you 14 points for one of them. For you don't get extra points for a deep throw or any of that. So let's take what the defense gives us. Let's move the ball as fast as we can down the field. You see that? The ball out of his hands quick. Now let's get up, get on the ball, go call the next play. Let's keep moving. Under 2 minutes, we'll go back to the old clock rules. The clock will stop for first downs. So you have a little bit of extra time, but we got to continually move the ball down the field.
That was to Duplessis. No one there, but McCall throws it out of bounds. Was chased out of bounds on that play by Kevin Swin.
It's a little frustration with McCall right there. He had a guy, he had a receiver open, decided to pull it down, didn't pull the trigger, just not playing as comfortable as we've seen him throughout his career tonight.
Up next for Deshaun DeClairs, they'll be at Georgia Southern. Georgia State has Troy, 3rd and 2. There's that first down they needed. Big run by Beasley. Upended. What a tackle. I mean, he tried to hurdle it. It was a hurdle gone bad, but 14 yards. Tyge Leach ended on that one. So there's the clock stop. Spotted. Starts. McCall. Dump down. They're just trying to get anything they can. That was Beasley.
They got to get up and get on the ball. And now after you check the ball down a couple of times, you're hoping to get the defense step up and take a shot down the field. Take a look at this hurdle right now. It's going to go up and over. Just not enough right there.
I mean, the effort was...
Love the effort. Fun play.
2nd and 5.
You see Georgia State in this prevent defense. A lot of people hate the prevent, but right now, hey, keep everything in front of you. Force the clock's going to run out before they run enough plays hoping to get into the end zone. So just keep it all in front of you. There's no need to force it or to do anything. But Grayson McCall, what they got to look like, and you got right now, first downs, stop the clock. Is it your first down or an out of bounds help you?
What a performance, man. You just saw Chad Staggs up on the screen, the defensive coordinator for Georgia State. Spent 4 years here on Jamie Chadwell's staff, who left to go to Liberty. Staggs got the job. his defensive coordinator, facing a lot of the guys that he recruited. So it is going to be an emotional night for him, but end result, win the game, and they are well on their way to doing that. Gain of 15. That was Pinckney.
Hurry up, get on the ball. The clock stops again. Try to get another first down. As many times you can stop the clock by getting the ball down the field is what's important. First downs and out of bounds. Stop the clock in these situations.
It's 10 yards at a time, so be it. And that's another first down.
Yeah. The clock will stop, set the chains, give you a shot. They're inside the 12. They're in the red zone again, and this is where they've struggled all night long.
So Baltazar picks up 12. And now a flag.
See the end of this play right here.
We've yet to make the call.
Personal foul. Roughing the unnecessary rough. Number 60, number 74. 15-yard penalty. Remains first down.
All right, so 64. Zavon Lindsay.
You know, I mean, by rule, you're not allowed to push guys or pull guys off the pile. I don't like it. They're laying on top, and he's trying to get his guy up. That's the rule. They got to enforce it. You don't like it.
But now under a minute, you've got to go quick now if you're Coastal.
Yeah, and the yard, I mean, that just kills you because now the clock's running this whole time, even though you get the yards back here.
Now there's a flag. There's movement.
False start. Offense. Number 64. 5-yard penalty. Remain second down.
A lot of frustration on the coaching staff and things they want to get cleaned up. To the Chanticleers, Tim Beck and his staff.
That's back-to-back penalties for Lindsay.
In these situations, that's going to be a 10-second runoff possibly in this situation as well. You know, basically ending the game. A lot of things they're going to have to learn and grow from.
10 penalties, 87 yards for Coastal.
27 seconds. This requires 10 seconds subtraction.
Mullen, you were ahead of them.
Coastal does not have any timeouts to prevent this subtraction.
That's it. I mean, now Georgia State, once they've gotten down in the red zone, you see the change. They're playing prevent. Now they're blitzing, coming after him every snap. It's going to give one-on-one shots down the field.
Did he?
No. Incomplete right there. They had kind of two receivers. See, even these situations, they had two receivers right there on top of each other, Tucker and Brown. See them kind of looking at each other.
It's, yeah.
Somebody's wrong in that scenario right there. And just these little things, they just haven't looked in sync offensively for most of the night.
So third and 17. Everybody talks about these clock rules speeding up the games.
I don't know.
Now it does.
I don't know. The blitz coming again.
So McCall to the right to Pinckney. That clock's going to run. Yeah, that's not going to do it. And Georgia State, with the Benziali tackle,
will end the game.
Yep. They've made program history, starting 3-0 for the first time. They keep making it. 4-0 to start the season for Georgia State. 30-17, the final. Coach, final thoughts here from Connie.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed with this Georgia State team. Coach Elliott's got this team. He's got a veteran group. He's got playmakers all over the field on the offensive side of the ball. And, boy, they can play some defense. They stop the run, and they run and hit you and get to this football.
What a win.
They're going to be a contender in this league.
What a win for Stags. What a win for Georgia State. For Harry Lyles, Dan Mullen, I'm Matt Berry. Ben Ward produced it. Ed Curran directed it. Final score, 30-17. Coming up next, SportsCenter with Scott Van Pelt.
Hi there, welcome. This is SportsCenter Live from the nation's capital. I am Scott Van Pelt. Just 10 days remain in Major League Baseball's regular season. See who improved their position today and who's left hanging their head. In the NFL, the Dallas Cowboys dealt a major blow, but they aren't the team whose season really could hang in the balance in week three. We'll explain. Thursday means one thing. It means
I want winners.
If you do too, well, you're in luck because I'm handing out as many picks as I have fingers. That's a tenner for free. First, best thing I saw today. This man has been overshadowed. Let's give him his flowers. Matt Olson in the district, swinging a drive. He's hit more majestic shots. He's hit plenty further. That's 53. 5-3 on the season for this man. This team seems like they win every day. They hit more homers than anybody. He's got more homers than anybody. 53. The Braves have won 98 games. Let's tip our cap to that, man. You see that 11 days remain in the Major League season, but the most RBI in a season? Olsen's messing around with that. Tied for the second most homers and most RBI in a season since the stat became official in 1920. Needs four more to break Eddie Mathews' record. 11 days left in the regular season. Hunt for October in full swing. Phillies in command for the National League wild card. Home series against the Metropolitans wearing those gorgeous powder blues. Alex Bohm, high and deep to left center field. Out of here. He's got 18. Phillies lead 3-2. Mark Vientos. That's a bank special right there. Just barely ties it up at four apiece. Bottom six, Nick Castellanos. Fill thine horn with oil and go. This is out of all ballparks. 28 bat flip, 5-4, Phillies. Jose Alvarado on the mound, top nine. A runner on, two outs. The guy up, you want to be in the box if you're a Mets fan. Nasty slider there. Castellanos gets the water bath. Alvarado got the strikeout. Phillies get the 5-4 win. Cubs clinging to that third and final wild card spot, but they've lost six of seven. This is the Pirates with runners on the corners. Miguel